Busy, busy morning. It's the Opie and Anthony Show. I don't know how we're going to get everyone's plugs in, but we're going to try. We got Patrice O'Neill.
Thank you.
This means you out there in radio land, you got to pay close attention. We're going to give, I think, three, maybe four plugs right now. Patrice O'Neill is going to be at Governor's Comedy Club out there on Long Island today and tomorrow.
Yes.
In Levittown, right? It's a great club. I haven't been there in a while, but Governor's...
I've never been there.
Governor's is a great club. They do a good job out there. It's going to be a nightmare getting out to Long Island, so you better leave now.
Yeah, I'm probably going to take your advice.
You got to leave real early, Patrice, or the 8 o'clock show is going to be disappointing because you're not going to be on that stage.
And you're talking leaving at 5 to get to a 9 o'clock show is leaving late.
5? Leave at... Jimmy said it, 2 or 3. Oh,
this way you can go. You're relaxed in the hotel.
Yeah.
You have no choice.
You're under the weather.
All right.
It's rush hour all the time going out to Long Island. Then you got Bob Kelly sitting next to Patrice stuffing his fat face. And he's going to be at Caroline's here in New York City.
What's his name?
Bob has cheese connecting his... It looks like the beginning of a great porno scene.
What an ending.
What the ending.
What the ending. Sure.
212-757-4100 is Caroline's. You there just one show tonight?
Friday, Saturday, 10:30, Sunday, 8 o'clock.
And we're all looking forward to the Comedy Central special that you taped a while ago. They're finally showing that.
January 18th, right?
And once again, I was at that taping, and Bobby was great. Absolutely great.
Really? Did you?
He was great. No joke. Standing ovation, everything.
Did you see my Def Jam set that's going to air Sunday?
No, but I've been obsessed. I told Patrice this. That hat, walking out like he's Big E, just a man who's got some face. I can't tell you how badly I wanted to use some sort of weapon to remove that hat. A pickaxe. What a great way to get that hat off.
I was trying to upgrade my appearance.
Sure. I think it looks good on you. I think you actually pull it off.
It annoys
me. Not many people can.
It annoys me that he's recreated himself as actually kind of a suave player, and it works, and it annoys me.
You know why? Because you're a big guy, and the hat and the leather and stuff, it's very intimidating. Even though I know you're, a pussy.
Well, tell people that. Nice guy.
Also, you've been animated by Coke Logic. It's cold out here or whatever, that bit you did with the rest area where the guy's knocking on the window looking for some action, and you're just in the rest area. You're in the rest area.
Tell me these things,
getting a few.
I just got a publicist. My publicist needs to know these things.
Well, the animation's doing very well on iTunes. We got to deal with iTunes right now.
Really?
You go to iTunes.
Can you tell
me? We're not getting money either.
I didn't ask for money. I just want somebody to know me.
It's just good promotion for the show. Some of these animations have made it to iTunes. You go to the podcast section. It's called O&A Shorts. You download them for free.
Really?
We're not asking for nothing. And they animated.
What's mine say, Patrice O'Neill?
It looks like you're there. Look, right there. That's how you look
animated.
There's
a creepy guy at the window.
Wow.
How cool is that?
And he just does it to the story.
Yeah.
He uses the audio from the show.
You know the ones they showed a traveling virus? It's kind of like that vibe. You just play the radio show.
Wow.
Yeah, and you just go to iTunes. They're throwing one up a week, I think. An animation up a week that you can download for free.
What? Just page me. Say something. I love that. I love myself in cartoon form for some reason.
Yeah, isn't that good when you're a cartoon?
Yo.
And you pull in, and then the creepy guy comes up to your window.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
How cool is that? There you are, animated, sleeping.
Oh!
You wake up because someone's knocking on your window.
And he's just standing there.
Oh, my gosh. That's what happened. That's him.
That's the creepy guy.
Is Coke Logic the dude?
Why does a creepy guy look like Norton?
Norton with his hair growing in a little bit.
Yeah, George Bush a little bit.
Yeah, young George Bush.
Holy...
Yeah, we're very proud of these animations. And
that
now on
is
iTunes.
Amazing. I'm glad whoever I don't
Coke
know.
Logic,
I'm so
really
happy
great.
He did that, man.
Great.
Logan got this deal done.
Really?
Yeah, it's great. Great promotion for the show. This is the way you do it, right here. You get iTunes involved. O&A Shorts podcast section.
That internet, the next big thing, I hear.
By the way,
be huge.
One of the top downloads on iTunes every week is these animations. People are eating them up. So there you go, Patrice.
Thanks for telling me. Yeah. 10 days into 2008. How long?
Started recently. It's a recent.
Yeah.
Wow, man.
And we got Louis C.K. joining the program as well. A very, very busy studio today.
You have any gigs you're doing, Lou?
I'm in Miami on Wednesday, but nobody cares.
What? Why Wednesday?
Wednesday.
Why?
It's part of the festival. They're having the South Beach Comedy Festival. And then after that, this weekend I'm in Knoxville, Tennessee, and Louisville, Kentucky.
Louisville for Louis C.K. Yeah, look at that.
My first time playing Louisville. Natural.
Cool. Bob, that'd be like you working in Douchetown.
You working in Tranny Town.
Oh. No, but he's not a tranny. Can you didn't, get, you didn't get how that would work.
It says for a free trial.
Yeah, yeah.
Stick up for him, Luke.
No, I mean that he has sex with trannies.
Hold on, everyone's talking at the same time.
Yeah, exactly.
I just wanted to know about this cartoon. I'm enamored with this cartoon.
Yeah.
Nobody cares
for
about
a free 14-day. Don't look it. Can you not take a little glory? I seen you with a big cartoon too, Mr.
I
Sneaky.
Think it's great, but we talked about it for a long time.
I don't
now.
Care. Wait a minute, Louis. Oh, just hold on.
Important.
See, I just it's something about pushy Hispanics.
You know what?
Pushy Hispanics. Louis C.K. This it says for
you
a
need, but you're a guy that needs to be cut off sometimes. Because you're
all the time, but I just
otherwise
need
it
to
would
know.
All be you. You're like you're not even you can't be a minority because any room with you you're so big and loud and talk a lot.
Why don't you just say Lynch so I can ask so for you. The firing?
So that you.
All right, listen.
If you're in a room, you're a majority. You're never a minority.
I wanna play some we got in yesterday.
A racial effect.
Hold on. We're gonna like direct this ship and then we're gonna go. Then we'll get crazy here. We got some audio yesterday. Clemens admitting that he did the steroids.
Are you kidding?
Now this has to be exclusive because I really haven't heard this anywhere.
Yeah, for some reason ESPN's not playing this yet.
Yeah,
I don't know why.
I wonder why.
It's shocking. The fan here in New York, they're avoiding this, but we got it.
Mm-hmm.
Exclusive audio. Clemens admitting the steroids.
Really?
Yeah. Check this out.
I want to say thanks to this Mitchell report. I've been getting emails and questions on this subject, and now the whole world knows the answer is that I use steroids. Over the last 15 days or so, when I played in Toronto for the Blue Jays, Brian McNamee used steroids to inject into my body. And I'm very thankful for those steroids. And this has been extremely difficult to do this. I'm almost numb to steroids and human growth hormones. I'm angry about it, to be honest with you. It's hurtful to have thousands of people to inject human growth hormone into my body. My friends to inject steroids into my body. The New York Yankees to inject human growth hormone into my body. My children use drugs and it means a lot to me. My family to inject steroids. Again, it's amazing to me that I have to even use steroids. And I want to say thanks to Brian McNamee of the New York Yankees. After Christmas, I'm going to sit down with Mike Wallace of 60 Minutes, and I'll inject drugs into my body right there in front of him, and we'll do all this again. And let me be clear that I'm very thankful for those steroids. And Mike Wallace used drugs now that that's come out. My children to inject steroids into Mike Wallace of 60 Minutes. I'm coming upon Christmas now, and I have been blessed in my life. I've been blessed in my career, and the answer is that I use steroids.
There you go.
Oh, is that funny?
Boy, they really spun that.
Yeah.
That's not how I... That is really wild.
I don't know how it got to where his children are injecting Mike Wallace with drugs.
Boy, but the filter, hey, that's what he said, but then by the time it gets filtered to you on ESPN...
Yeah, it's completely different.
Totally murky.
Totally murky.
At least we had the uncut version.
Yeah,
exactly.
Somebody had
you
a little too much time on their hands.
love that. Do I believe... Nah. No.
No?
He did something.
Just can't prove it.
Yeah.
It's just weird that guy did it. Andy Pettit, who's like really, by you know, really Christian and stuff. I don't know. Like, he's done ads for books about God on TV.
Yeah.
So he just told the truth. And said, yeah, I'm ashamed and I'm sorry. So,
did it like once and,
yeah.
And he's to recover quickly. And
this guy, Brian McNamee, was introduced like... Clemens introduced him to Pettit and told Pettit, you gotta use this guy.
Yeah.
And so what? This guy said to Pettit, listen, Roger doesn't do this steroid stuff, but you should.
You should.
This one time. And I mean, I can't get Roger to do them. It's weird.
Yeah, he just won't do them.
Yeah, he won't. But you should do them. And Pettit was like, yeah, I mean, whatever, sure. Why
not? Yeah, I'll try.
That accusing somebody of something is the thing that bothers me, but... The thing that I would think that gets me is in terms of believing that he might did it is the argument of you don't get better when you get 40.
Yeah, exactly.
Physically.
Yeah.
That's what all the Hall of Fame, that's what Goose Gossage said. Come on. You're that old and you got better?
Yeah, he got
one
better.
Thing, like, Nolan Ryan was probably the last non-steroid older baseball guy, and he just managed to sputter into his 40s a little bit.
Yeah.
Threw a no-hitter and then got out.
Yeah.
But Clemens, when Clemens threw a piece of bat at Piazza, I was like, yeah, that guy's on drugs. He's got mental problems from things that shouldn't be inside of him.
But he's doing the right thing as far as putting doubt in people's minds. All you have to do with a situation like this, there's no proving it.
No.
There's no actual videotape. There's not. We love proof. We love catching people red-handed in these days.
Yep.
And there's none of that. So all he has to do is say, look, I didn't do it. And I'm going to sit down here. I'm going to tell you how I didn't do it. I'm going to do interviews saying I didn't do it. And then people will go, you know, maybe he didn't.
The power of denial is unbelievable. Yeah. When I was a kid, I got caught. I stole triple beam balances from my science class. I sold them to drug dealers for a pot. I was in eighth grade. I was like 12 years old.
All right.
I stole like 20 of them because I figured out how to get into the science. Anyway, I got caught. And they just knew I did it. And I just kept saying, no, I didn't.
Nope.
I kept saying I didn't. I don't even know what you're talking about. No. I don't even do drugs. I don't smoke pot. I just kept saying it, and I just wore them down.
You ever watch?
And I didn't. They finally said, well, we can't really.
Why is that not working for Barry Bonds?
That's true, though. If you just deny it.
Why is Barry Bonds getting ready to go to court for lying about something that you're saying that no one can prove it?
All he's got to do is keep denying.
Keep denying. No, but it's different because he's black.
I didn't want to say that.
Yeah, well,
let's be honest.
Of course, that's why.
I mean, let's just
when black people deny anything, it's the opposite for black people.
Oh, right, I forgot to tell
you. For black people, it's the opposite. When they deny something, you go, "Oh, geez,
Juice has been denying it for
years. Look at him lie." Jesus, what a liar. No, it's exactly. We have to premise this whole thing. All white people have to do.
Right, is deny.
And eventually people go, oh, come on, give them the benefit of the doubt.
Black people have to confess or else it's just going to get hot on you. If you watch any of those crime shows.
And they have to change the entire system.
But even if you didn't do it, you have to confess. Even if you didn't do it, you should just say you did.
I love those shows. I love the crime shows on A&E where they show the confessions, and they bring people in, and a lot of times the people that just stick to the denial, it goes into the cold case files, and maybe they get them 20 years later.
Yeah.
But it's the people that are sitting there, and it's like, come on now, look, we got this, and they never really have anything, but it goes, all right, I was in the car when he was shot, and then before you know it, the guy's like, I shot the man, killed him, problem solved, crime solved. Just deny it.
Yeah, but the more you say, you have to just say no. No.
When they ask
you,
but it is true.
No.
No.
Because the more you talk, they're going to get you. It's like the cops. I was with this lady one time that you pay to give you back rubs in L.A.
Okay.
And as soon as we were done, I actually just put my sneaker on, knock, 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 cops right at the door. And they came in, and they had me. They took me on the curb. They just started going, come on, man. What was going on there? Were you just getting a bad...
The only reason they're asking is because they need you to say, yes,
yeah,
I was
but they
doing
kept
that.
Asking they me, like, you know,
on you
I just kept going, nope. Nope.
No.
No. But they were getting me to like buddy, like, we were, and I was like, no. And they finally were like, look, he's not saying anything. And they let me go. They were pissed too.
But that really is the difference between life for whites and blacks. But if you're white and you kill somebody on television, as long as you just keep denying it, you're going to get out of it.
Yeah.
If you're black and you were home sleeping and someone 4,000 miles away got killed, and they ask you if you did it, you better just say you did it.
Just confess.
They're going to get you. They're going to hang it on you.
Unless Monk is around.
I was driving through a questionable area one time where there were prostitutes. And let's just say I had glasses many, many years ago. Let's just say there was a transsexual who walked over and snatched my glasses. And then I was sitting there.
Why did she want your glasses?
What's that?
Why did she want your glasses?
Thank you for at least sheeing it up and keeping the illusion going.
And I was
It's out of respect
there.
For her. I'm
let's
respecting
was,
her choice.
I was sitting there. And let's just say I couldn't drive because I couldn't see. And I saw a police car.
Oh, God.
And I saw a police car. And I had to high beam the police car. And say, he took my glasses. And the policeman had to walk over and go, did you take his glasses?
Oh, my God.
And this person had to go, yes. And the policeman had to say, give the glasses back.
Oh, my God.
Because the policeman said, what are you doing around here? I said, I'm lost.
And you lost and a tranny stole your glasses?
Stole them right off my face. right through the window.
Why did she steal them?
I have no idea.
She was mad at you for something.
Why did he steal them? Let's just...
No, come on.
Let's stop this. Let's stop humoring him.
Yeah,
why did that man with breasts in your glasses? Fella,
why did that gentleman?
I don't know. I actually don't know. They're crazy. They carry razors soaked in garlic.
You know, I don't know. Garlic.
They're not emotionally healthy people.
Why garlic?
The genitals of both sexes.
Was there a why garlic? Because Norton was like Nosferatu.
Yeah.
They have their genitals duct taped to their.
Was there a conversation going on?
No. Yes, it was.
Oh, thank you, Opie. Just stop.
The window was down. There was something.
Can we have an intervention about this little homosexual?
No. I'll tell you. I was at a stop sign. It was in the meatpacking district. There was a bunch of trannies.
Stop sign. In the meatpacking district.
Yes.
Okay. Fair enough.
Of course, I was riding around looking at whores, but I wasn't talking to this one. I didn't see it coming.
Oh, so just an arbitrary hooker. That happened to be a dude just came and took your little glass.
That's
off your
what
face.
I'm trying to tell you. Right. And snatched
a guy, a girl walked up that looked like Daryl Strawberry, and you just started talking to her.
Nobody would talk.
I'm gonna tell you what happened. Norton had one of those little, those little tirades that he has if Kenny's around, but he forgot Kenny wasn't there, and a big transvestite stole your glass.
First of all, transvestite is different, and you don't no like then, you don't want to be lumped in with Haitians. They don't want to be lumped in with.
Oh my God.
A little respect. A little respect.
Oh, damn it, Norton.
Transsexual.
What's the difference? Long before I ever heard of Kenny. That's before I think before I even did comedy. It was,
he cursed out. He cursed the tranny out for something.
Yeah, something went.
My glasses got taken off.
He doesn't want to share it.
So why would they just reach into in your window and took your glasses?
Yeah, because I wouldn't. I'll tell you what it was.
There you go.
I wasn't buying.
It was a very aggressive, aggressive salesman.
It was, yes.
Who was leaning and going, come on, I swear this would be a good experience.
It was somebody
for
that
you.
Goes,
you're and you're going,
looking,
no, thank you.
Because you were looking for something prettier.
I was not going to pick up. You understand how my addiction works.
You were trying to actually get some meat. You were trying to get some steaks at the meatpacking district.
Yes, I was riding around looking for
it was a huge misunderstanding.
No, because I wasn't picking up, and that's what it was about. It was just, she got annoyed and snatched it. It was like that fast, and I had no communication with this person whatsoever. None. And I had to tell the police. She took my glasses. And the police had to get them.
Hilarious.
And they said, get back the glasses.
There you go, Coke Logic. Oh. There's your next animation.
Yeah, please.
I just visualized that
one. I'd love to see that one.
Oh, hey, we got to take
a Magoo, you've done it again. You couldn't see?
Do you know what it's like to sit in your car in a sea of men in dresses and not be able to drive away?
Sir.
I can't go anywhere. I got bad eyesight, folks.
Sir.
Thanks, LASIK.
A blurry thing stole my glasses.
Yeah. I'll ask this nice young lady if she could help me.
Oh,
confused, self-hating blur took my.
You just had to sit there until you got your glasses.
That was horrendous.
Oh, hey, quick break. We got a break. And when we get back, we'll get into the Dr. Phil thing. Cause we got a lot of people in studio that do the Xbox, and you know, it's being used to yell and scream racist stuff. And Dr. Phil is tackling this. Very important issue. As we go to break, our homeless friend, Tippy Tom, most of you guys know Tippy Tom. He came in and we had him do a little books on tape for everybody. So check this out as we go to break.
The Opie and Anthony Institute of Art and Literature is proud to present a collection of books on tape soulfully voiced by the homeless, Tippy Tom.
I can't do as good as that guy to do it, but you know.
Masterpieces like Herman Melville's Moby Dick.
Call me Ishmael. Some years ago, never mind how long precisely.
And Dickens historically themed A Tale of Two Cities.
It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. I'm doing a good job. Okay.
You won't believe your ears as Tom mutters and fumbles his way through Mark Twain's classic, Huck Finn.
Huck Finn's wealth and the fact that he was under the window Douglas's protection. Okay, I guess I'm getting it right.
And then be prepared to have your breath taken away, literally, with his read of Great Expectations.
Heaven knows we'd never be ashamed of our tears, okay? Of course not. Anyway, I think I got sort of it right.
And finally, you'll enjoy the classic for all ages, Dr. Seuss's Green Eggs and Ham.
Great eggs and ham. No, green eggs and ham. See, I thought I can't see where my glasses are. I am Sam. I am Sam. Sam, I am.
Come on, man, I got my damn glasses on.
Who even knew Tippy Tom had glasses?
No.
It's a collection of some of the finest literature ever written, and then read by a homeless drunk. Order Tippy Tom Books on Tape today.
Hey, good morning. It's the Opie and Anthony Show. Let me set the scene here. It's a very, very, very busy morning. We got Patrice O'Neill on the couch. We got Bob Kelly on the couch. We got Louis C.K. to my right. We got Basil Tease in the corner making omelets for everybody. And we got English Gavin, who's 6'5", 290 pounds, not a hint of fat on his body. He's got the binoculars, and he's checking out the girl exercising naked.
And he's uncut.
He's uncut. Bob Kelly needs to add to
that. I'm taking a sauna with him.
Right. Hey, Gavin, how's it going out? How's it going out the window this morning? Yeah, that mic's on, not on. Why would it be?
Why would it be?
Why would that microphone be on? It needs to be that one? Okay. Gavin, what are you seeing out the window?
I'm seeing nothing right now. She's still wearing clothes, and unfortunately, she's trying to read a magazine and whatnot, but she's really teasing me.
Yeah, she does get naked.
I want to climb over that fence and just...
What about the naked chicks in the magazine?
Yeah. Oh, actually, she actually has, yeah.
Gavin, we've seen her naked many, many times. Wow. You're not missing much.
Is she a white girl? Oh, really?
Well, yeah. She's
Gavin
got a...
loves white girl. He's going to do the blade girls. Jump right over to that...
The blade jump.
Gavin does. He actually, a bit of white. I like white
girls. He did a girl over my apartment. My girlfriend's best friend, he came over... Romanced her in like 4 hours, and then that night just blasted her on my couch. The girl fell in love with him. This white girl from Boston fell in love with this black Englishman, and he dumped her.
And he's such a Viking. He's just probably
a Viking.
Me and Don were holding each other in the bed, like, oh my god, like there was a monster attacking her.
On a period as well.
He drank out of his helmet and left.
It was a bad day.
I drank out of her skull.
He just blasted her. You were scared for your life, what you were hearing?
We were just holding each other like, she's going to be okay, honey. She's like, go out there and help her. I'm not going out there. It's Gavin. He's uncut. He'll grab me with that thing and throw me like an elephant.
It's prehensile.
His big English jammy looks like a pug's face.
Friends.
Of course. That was a compliment.
Yes. And then we got to get back to Jimmy, too. The instant feedback, everybody's pointing out.
I completely forgot.
Especially Steven S. from Bayshore. You got to give Josh from Ohio some credit as well. And Kevin from Connecticut also saying the same thing, that the tranny in that situation you described
before. Me. Yeah, I completely forgot. I've told the story. And what had been happening, I've been riding around in this circle, and the tranny did say, for wasting my time, because I wouldn't stop.
That's why she took his glasses.
Why.
And my shoes.
So I completely forgot about that.
Oh, it was awful. Officer, I need my glasses back. The gentleman dressed like a woman took them from me, and I can't see, goddammit.
You must have been pathetic.
No, that makes you feel really good.
I tried to drive away, but I hit something with a penis.
Well, you know, every good gentleman has a fault.
Yeah. Well, and just when you thought the show couldn't get any crazier, we got Howie Mandel standing by. He's on the phone here. Howie!
Yes.
How are you, buddy?
Have you reached the guest quota yet?
Well,
yeah, I know, really.
I think this is the most mics we've had on in a very long time.
That worked.
But we wanted to squeeze you in there, Howie.
Thanks. It's an honor to be part of this extravaganza.
Yeah, it is an extravaganza. We got a girl ready to be naked and exercising across the way.
She know she's going to be on the radio?
She will.
Well, you know what, Howie? This girl knows that people are looking at her because she has no shades, no blinds. Every morning,
keeps it open.
Every morning, it's the same routine. She takes all her clothes off. She jumps on an exercise bike. Which isn't doing any help whatsoever.
She got a big ass, and she's not really into shaving.
She's naked on an exercise bike?
Every morning,
well,
without fail.
It's not about the exercise if she's sitting on one of those seats pedaling.
You said there's a seat.
Yeah, there's no seat.
It's not about losing weight.
No.
Just smelling up the seat.
And then she goes and she showers. She comes back out naked, hangs out for a while a little more naked. Yeah. And, you know, no
goes
blinds.
In the closet. Yeah,
every single light in her apartment is on. She's not trying to hide anything.
You know what? She does have blinds. It's just that they're pointed so that if you look... Like, you don't think about, when you have blinds, you don't think about the people that are above you looking down through the slats.
But you gotta, you've got to alert her. It would be great to alert her live on the air. Which next time she's naked on the bike, send somebody down to buzz the apartment.
Well, we got to figure out which apartment it is somehow.
Obi, I think that balloon glove Howie could have talked about this more in depth. But deal or no deal, Howie can't do it.
No, Howie.
Deal or no deal, Howie. No, this is dangerous territory for deal or no deal, Howie.
I can do this.
I'm in town doing live, on Saturday and Sunday. I'm at Westbury Music Fair, and I'm at the Bergen County Theater in Englewood, New Jersey. I'm filthy. It's not the deal or no deal.
I'm going to back up Howie. He's been on our show ever since the deal or no deal has become huge, and he's told us some horrific things.
Really?
Tonight he's actually on Monk. His Monk episode airs tonight.
Right, but that's not filthy. That's me ridding Tony Shalhoub of his need to wipe his hands. That's who they hired me.
Yeah. It is. Hey, Howie, you wouldn't want to be in the studio, by the way. I'm getting over the flu. Patrice has it. Jimmy's been sneezing all week. Anthony's had a couple sneezes going on the last few days.
Bob Kelly's ugly.
Bob Kelly's ugly.
But I just bought a bidet.
Yeah, but Bob Kelly told us about his bidet, and we were bragging about yours yesterday, Howie.
I told you about that toilet, right?
Yeah, of course
you did.
Not
only a bidet, you don't touch anything.
No.
You don't touch toilet paper anymore.
No, no.
Have you ever had a cold?
Wow.
Yes, I get sicker more than any. I get more.
So what's your point?
Wait a minute. How do you use a bidet to wipe
everything?
Like no. This has.
Does it have like acid in it? Like, what if you have like a really sticky poo?
No, this power wash.
Really? You just
power
blast
it? Set it on power wash and then blow dry.
Those foam strips like a car wash come out and just lather it up and wax it.
I don't know if I told you last time, I accidentally hit the button that said front wash, and it was like one of those speed bags.
It's $1,000 that toilet seat.
Way more than that.
No, it's not the seat. I got the Neil Rest 600. It's like $5,000. I got all the... I walk into the bathroom at night. I don't even have to touch the light. The seat automatically raises, and there's a beautiful glow. A light comes.
You know
out.
Who you are, Howie. You were the old man from the original Creep Show.
What?
Remember the roach guy? All the roaches.
They creep up on you.
Yeah, they creep up on you. It's just,
bugs.
I don't
bugs.
Touch nothing. You gotta touch something, Howie.
No, I touch nothing. I go through life touching nothing. And then not only that, as soon as you sit down, it's like a warm. The seat is heated to a
I have that.
You have that.
I have that.
Yeah, well, Bob Kelly's got the cheap version.
Yeah, but first of all, he's got deal or no deal money. I got Caroline's three-show money.
Bob Kelly's seat you have to heat with matches.
Just what I save on toilet paper alone, it's worth it.
I don't even use toilet paper anymore.
$5,000, so it's like the bidet from France. Like the
Japan,
what
I think.
Reasons, though. Bob wants comfortable craps because, like me, every time he takes a dump, it's an emergency. Because we both have bad diets, and things come violently rocketing out of our asses. And so we need at least to be comfortable during the trauma. We give birth every time we poop.
Yeah.
Howie is crazy and has mental problems and he can't touch
this. I made it a whole, it's kind of, for me, it's like a hobby now. It's
right.
Like, I got a flat screen TV I put in right in front of it.
I got that.
I put a phone.
And Ted Bundy's hobby was killing nurses.
How much does it cost to install that?
The toilet?
Yeah, like the install, the whole plumber thing.
Honestly, I think I was exaggerating. I think the whole thing is like $3,000 totally installed.
Yeah. Poor Howie. Every time he comes on our show, he has to talk about his germs and his toilet.
He's
that's
all
we talk to him about.
The toilet is fascinating.
Howie. That's my life.
Yeah.
Howie, do you find yourself sitting on the toilet longer and longer every day?
Like, absolutely.
I'm getting addicted to the feeling of it cleaning me.
My life revolves around crapping since I got this toilet. That's my schedule, and then I fit everything around it.
Hey, can I tell a Howie-related story, by the way?
Yeah.
Howie, this is Louis C.K. Remember?
I remember you, Louis. You know I'm a huge fan.
Well, Howie he took me to open for him a few gigs, and we were in Poughkeepsie at the Howling, whatever it is there.
Yeah.
So they gave us the Motel 8 or whatever as a dressing room, and I went. Howie didn't, he just ate dinner and stayed, and then we left. But I went to the dressing room and the Motel 8 people had created this presidential suite for Howie. Like they must have gone out and gotten special furniture, and there was a gift basket. And there was a note saying the owner of the hotel loves Howie more than anything and would love a picture with him. And we did this room just for you. And I look at this stuff and I just was like, screw him. And I didn't tell Howie.
You never told him.
Never told him.
Like, I was in a bad mood. I was bitter for some reason.
Oh,
probably because I was opening for Howie Mandel at the Howling Wolf in Poughkeepsie.
The Laughing Wolf.
Yeah, and I just didn't tell
anybody.
Well,
you weren't bitter enough to trash the room.
No, exactly.
And write back, fuck you.
Yeah.
Exactly. Oh, excuse me.
That's all right.
Oops.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, oops.
Yeah, well.
Hey, are you any better with Howie?
I don't know. Am I talking on? Is this?
No, this is regular radio. Are you any better with the germs now, or is it the same thing?
Why, like, within 3 months, how did I get cured? No.
Well, no, but anybody. Is there any progress at all?
No. No.
No.
What did you hear I was doing that would enhance the progress?
Yeah.
Nothing. I just figured that we've talked about it. Now we're talking about it again, so maybe you had progressed.
Would you be more
bit.
Uncomfortable if a black man or a white man licked your face? Let's just get down to the nitty gritty.
Black man, 'cause there'll be a home invasion happening.
Oh, God.
Yeah, well, no, but Howie, do you get counseling for it or anything, or is it something?
Yeah, I'm constantly. My therapist lives in a beautiful gated community.
Yeah,
it's a yes. I'm in cognitive therapy now.
And you're married, right?
Cognitive.
Yes.
You've got kids, right?
So here's the question:
3 kids. I will sit. Some therapy sessions are just sitting there, shaking hands.
So you're married, Howie. Now here's the question: raw, Diggy? You know, raw.
Raw. What?
I mean, saying,
do you wear a condom?
Yeah,
with your
right.
Wife?
You go raw.
No, yeah, I don't shake her hand. Yes, I go raw. Yeah.
All right, I'm just checking.
That doesn't bug you?
No, that.
You do it like a Hasid through a sheet or something?
Yeah, yeah. Are you like a surgeon when you
Halloween,
have sex?
And then on Halloween, my kids go out as one-eyed ghosts.
one bloody-eyed ghost. Oh, pussy bloody eye.
All right.
The one-eyed cyclop ghost has pink eye.
Pink eye.
Oh, man.
Wow. Oh. Trying to get most of this on the radio,
oh,
by the way.
That's funny.
Come on.
That is really
it's so indirect. It takes you so much work to get to the bad.
Yeah, to get there.
Hey, Howie, still loving Deal or No Deal. And like I said, every time you come on our show, it's because of you. I mean, it's such a dumb concept, but I
can't not watch it. I have to watch it.
I watch because of Howie, because somehow he just makes it work. I don't get it.
We're in the middle of a $1 million mission now. We're gonna and hopefully somebody's gonna walk out of there with $1 million. That's the mission.
Is Howie,
every time somebody doesn't win $1 million, we're adding another case with $1 million, and we're going to do it up to 57 cases.
Jesus.
Wow.
Howie, that show made me cry once.
Why?
It really did make me cry.
Teary-eyed?
Yes.
Well,
it was a Marine.
Did somebody win?
It was a Marine who came over from, he just came back from the war, and he had like 2 days here in New York, and they mentioned he couldn't see his family. There wasn't time to go to California to see them. So he's in his moment where he's going to see his kids come out and his wife. He didn't know they weren't coming.
Oh, yeah.
So everybody's crying. Right. And then that moment that he hits that every idiot on that show hits, where you've got...
Or it's time to walk away.
You've got 150. It's always like at 125,000.
Yeah, right.
That basically, if you're in your living room, you're like, there's $125,000 in front of you. And you're saying no, you just garbage human being.
But at that point,
he hit that point, and he said to his kids, like everyone was screaming, you know, no deal. And he said to his little girls, he said, you see what's happening here? $125,000, and there's there's a 1 in 4 chance that the odds are really good that I'll get more. And I'm not gonna gamble with your futures that way. And he said, no deal. And I just started bawling.
Really?
No, the thing that's great about that show though is that everyone screams no deal. Everyone wants it. But then the second the person takes the deal, the whole audience, thank God. We're all crazy. Thank God you're not crazy.
Can I want to see a disaster? One that bothered me along the same lines was we had a woman on whose husband was in Iraq, and we went live to Fallujah.
Oh.
The guy's in the battlefield, and we're looking at him with night vision goggles.
Wow!
And you know, he's just a young kid. He's out there. He's in the worst part of wherever the war was going on. And she had gotten to a point where there wasn't much left on the board. I don't remember. And the offer was 6 figures, which would have changed the life. And he said, and she goes, "Honey, what should I do?" And from Fallujah, with we have a horrible signal. He says, "Take the money, honey. Just take the money." And then the satellite went out. We lost the guy.
Oh.
And she goes, "You know what? He doesn't know. No deal." He went home with a buck.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
he must have.
What a bitch.
What I do, he must have beat her savagely.
When I do it home, when it gets to the you know, the figure Louie was talking about, $100,000, $125,000, mm-hmm. and they don't take that money,
right.
you want them to take that money. And as soon as they say no deal, now you go the other way, and you're like, man, I hope he gets a dollar. I got to watch now and watch him lose it all.
Well, the Marine that took the money,
do you remember
what was the
that
next case?
Do you remember that show, Howie, that Marine?
I don't remember the Marine.
He was so good.
Louis, what was after that? Do you remember?
I don't remember, but it was a I don't remember that part of it where then they break his heart that he could have had more.
Look at Anthony. Look at Anthony like, this sissy talk.
No, I watched the show.
I'm betting until I lose.
Well,
he's like all this betting.
No, I probably would be totally different on those game shows.
Right. Howie, do you remember the Chinese guy who had come here with $75?
I love that. No, that's $750.
Yeah, came here with $750.
Yeah, the Korean guy.
And he was like immigrant, and so now this is his family playing the show. And
well,
he said
that you know his family came from Korea with one bag with $750 in it and two kids. So chase the American dream, and these two Korean, this couple put their kids through school and college, and now the kid was just getting married, and he's on a game show. He says, I made it. It all started from $750, and I made it. And he starts playing the game, and then as luck would have it, all that's left on the board is $750,000,
yeah.
$75,000, and $750.
It's just weird.
And then the offer comes in. The offer's like $300,000+. And he says deal. He takes the deal. But it was amazing that he'd started with 750, his father, 750, 75,000, 750,000. The numbers look great. I said, let's see if you had made a good deal, Had you said no deal to the 350, what would your next choice be? As he opens the next case, $750,000 is revealed. So he got out at the perfect time.
Yep.
And then we open up his case to see what he had sold. He sold his case for $350,000. We open his case. And his case that he started the game with was a case holding $750.
Yeah, the same amount.
Just like he came over.
But there was a moment
of heroin.
But there was a moment in that show when they had revealed all that, where the old man was crying. Like the old man was
saying, the old man breaks into crying. He's sitting down there. The old man breaks crying. I take the case with the $750, and I walk it down in the audience, and I put it back in his lap.
That's right. But here's the thing: everyone, he was crying.
I think I've ever saw. Which was that, ladies and gentlemen, is the circle of life.
Jesus Christ.
I saw,
yeah, but here's the thing.
Price is Right break her back doing Plinko. I cried.
I had a totally different view of that show, though, because that guy was crying. He didn't say a word the whole time because he doesn't speak English.
Right.
He's crying at the end, and everyone's standing and applauding. And I thought, and it was supposed to be because how great this is, but I thought the guy was crying because look what materialistic douchebags my family have turned into.
Yeah, he's all upset.
He was like, my whole life struggle was a waste because these people have no values and they just chase money on a game show when I came
Louis,
here.
Louis, do you care about any black people, any black stories on there?
That's, what's that?
You know, some kid from Compton who lost his Air Force One.
No,
maybe.
I don't
any
care.
Any black cry stories?
Black
no,
kid came in
no.
and stole all the cases and ran off of them.
That's what.
Hey, how
the black kid stole that card with the money on it, thinking it was worth something. Like he stole the case, thinking
Chinese
he could actually,
immigrants. I cried for
spend
what?
That money.
Hey, Howie, the other thing I like, and you guys don't do it all the time, but you show the case going into commercial, so the people at home know exactly what's in the case before the guy makes his decision.
You like that? I didn't like that as much.
I kind of like that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'll give them the note.
It doesn't matter, I guess. Yeah, but,
Opie and, liked this.
But what I like about the show, you're always throwing a different twist into it. And
we are.
And the theme shows and all that.
Does the banker, doesn't he just say, hey, Howie, suck my blank or something? Doesn't he just say, right?
Or, yes.
Yeah, it's all set up way in advance.
No. He really has the offers.
But it doesn't take him that long to just say the money. He just says, hey, Howie.
He either tries to throw me or he says horribly disgusting stuff about the contestant. And I
tell that fat, smelly pig that I'll give her $50,000 for a case with maggots in it.
Not too far off. Yeah, because it gets boring for you guys.
Oh, that's
keep it
funny.
I don't know if you watched the other day, but he actually, some woman had as a lucky charm her little girl's piggy bank.
Mm-hmm.
And he took it, and I thought he was going to take it. He actually smashed it.
Oh, my God. He
did.
He smashed
it? And I thought he was faking it. He actually smashed this little girl's piggy bank, and this woman's game just went down the toilet. I mean, he is... Evil.
That's great.
Yeah.
All right, Howie. So what do we got? You're going to be on Regent. You're hosting today, right?
Yeah, I'm there now, so I got to go run.
Oh.
And I'm hosting, and I'll be at the Bergen Theater on Sunday and on Saturday at Westbury Music Fair.
Where the hell's Regis that he couldn't be there?
I have no idea.
It's very angry.
I'll find out. I'll find out. Hey, good to talk to you guys again. Louie, great to talk to you.
Yeah, Howie, take it easy.
Okay.
All right, Howie Bye. Mandel, everyone. Got to take a quick break. We're going to get into the Dr. Phil thing with the Xbox being
racist.
I want
to hear this.
Yeah, we got to squeeze that in before we get out of here. But first, it's the FU line.
Thanks for calling the Opie and Anthony FU line. Here's the latest batch of FUs.
You have 6 new voice messages. First voice message.
I'd like to leave a big you to driving in the left-hand lane on 93 southbound. We think it's cool to drive at 40 miles an hour while I'm trying to get to work and I'm already late. You.
Next message.
So I want to put a big you to my boss who decided not to give anybody in the company Christmas bonuses to fly his ass to California for vacation. I hope your plane crashes and you die on the way back. F you.
Next message.
Hey, I'd like to leave a you to the Department of Personnel in New Jersey for up the fire department lieutenant promotional exam. You, DLC. You.
Next message.
I just want to give a big FU to whoever got in this accident that I have to sit in right now. You. I hope you died.
Next message.
I like to give a big FU to my boss for tracing in late every day and then getting on my ass for wasting time. You!
Next message.
I'd like to give a big you to Iowa. I'm sick about hearing about your caucuses. Suck my
end of new messages.
Call the Opie and Anthony FU line. 866-FU-LINE-1. That's 866-FU-LINE-1.
Thank you and goodbye.
Right back into it. Opie and Anthony. Jimmy arguing with Tom down the hall. Patrice O'Neill.
Oh, yeah. Always the argument.
Playing governors on Long Island all weekend. We got Bob Kelly playing Carolines all weekend here in New York City. We got Louis C.K. Where are you going to be again, Louis?
Well, you know what? February 14th. What's that holiday? St. Valentine's Day. This is a big Opie and Anthony weekend for me. St. Valentine's Day, I'm in Buffalo. And
nice.
Then the next night, I'm in Cleveland. Then the next night, Michigan, Detroit. Oh,
there you go.
So that's all you guys' stuff. I'll be back, obviously, to plug those. But they're all going on sale, like, today.
They took us off the air in Detroit.
They did?
Not on satellite audience terrestrial. So they're still being heard in Detroit.
Actually, yeah. The satellite audience in the Detroit area, huge.
Well, we went on the air and we're almost sold out. I mean, we went on sale. And I know that's all O&A people.
Yeah, no,
there's no way that anybody in Detroit cares about me except for
Lucky Louie.
Yeah, but it's just Detroit. Like, I went on sale a bunch of markets, and Detroit just went through the roof immediately. Okay. And I think it has to be from you guys.
It's a huge satellite market.
Yeah.
We noticed that this past summer. So, you got anything accomplished down the hall there, Jimmy?
No, I mean, there was a couple of the dumps. I know why they did them, and there was one particular that bugged me. So I talked to Tom, and he was in the room when it was dumped, and he told him to dump it. I still don't 100% agree with it, but I do understand. It. When he went through the progression of why he felt it should be dumped, it's like, all right, I mean, we're not going to win every battle, and that one I can kind of go, all right, I understand his thinking.
I think Tom's hanging in the dump room today.
Yeah.
Knowing that everybody's in today.
Yeah. Tom's a smart guy when it comes to that.
And he went progressively through his thinking, and I was like, all right, whatever.
I think you guys got him frazzled today.
Yeah.
Working extra hard. So, hey, Dr. Phil, we're going to try to get this on before we get out of here. Dr. Phil talks about racist Xbox and cyberbullying.
Racist Xbox?
Yes.
Well, this was something we were talking about yesterday.
I bought an Xbox, and I don't see any racism going on on the...
I would have to deny that, too.
Oh, Jesus.
they're all playing Call of Duty
4,
and, you know, you get the trash talk, but it gets a little ugly in those... in those rooms. And Dr. Phil kind of wants to maybe put a stop to this.
Well, how is he going to put a stop
to
it?
So this isn't something that's in the Xbox. It's stuff that kids are saying to each other while
they're playing. Kids, adults.
Well, say me and Anthony were in a room.
Right.
If me and Anthony were in a room and then the other team comes in after.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then the guy from the other team, the first thing out of his mouth is, yo, we're going to kick your asses. You know, then some stuff, sometimes some people say, some stuff after that.
Yeah, it gets it can get racist and homophobic also, even though we're so not...
But that's like saying, like, a guy goes up to a guy on the street and calls him a Jew or whatever.
Yeah.
And then, so they go, we got to take that street down. right?
Right.
Is that basically what it is? It's just
pretty much that's
just
what he's
saying.
Just
another meeting place for people to act awful towards each other.
Yeah, while they're playing a game.
Yeah, but it's got nothing to do
together.
With Xbox.
That's no,
a damn good people point, are. Man.
No, it's just another communication vehicle.
Yeah.
It is ridiculous.
It's just that white people will call black people those words if they can do it from a safe distance.
Yeah, of course. I'll tell you what happens.
We're in the living room.
I'll tell you what happens. We play Call of Duty 4, okay. Which is one of the best games ever. And Bobby Kelly here General Bobby Kelly came up with the clan name. They call them clans, by the way.
That doesn't help.
No offense. But it's like a team. And ours is... G-A-A-Y. It's, you know, team gay with two gays. And so in front of your name, in little brackets, it says G-A-A-Y. And that way you know that we're all on one team. Right. So the second we get in a room with another team, they just instantly start, and it's just nothing but homophobic.
Yeah, it's so stupid because you guys are owning it. Like you're going and calling yourselves
We're calling ourselves the gay.
And they're acting like you didn't notice that it's spelled
That it's spelled gay.
Yeah. It doesn't help that we're like, hey, guys.
We greet them when they come into the rooms that way.
That must make them so mad.
And they get very angry, and people don't want to play us. And if there are teams, because there are teams then of specifically Jewish guys, there's the Jews. Their name of the team is Jews.
Right.
And they'll play, and there's certain black teams that'll play.
Right.
And
so it turns into all of that.
It just turns into gay bashing and racial bashing back and forth.
And so Dr. Phil wants to punish the
game.
Well, let's find out. And he's right. Dr. Phil is right.
Let's find out. And the greatest part about it is the fact that you're saying these things, which is fine, but you're playing a game that is probably the most violent game I've ever played in my life. It's fantastically violent. I love it. And it shouldn't be any other way, but you are blowing people up.
Yeah, but don't call him a faggot.
Yeah, don't say that. Perish the thought.
Really?
Yeah, they probably would have a problem with that.
I shouldn't be on this show.
The thing that stinks about the game is so politically correct that we're actually still fighting Russians.
Right?
It's
the only acceptable enemy.
It just went to Russians, too. We actually were still fighting Germans up until last year. Now, we're actually fighting Russians.
Germans are always the bad guys.
With laser scopes, which we didn't even fight them
even
with laser
scopes. Even though we fought Korea between those two, you can't do Koreans.
The people.
But wait a minute. What about
Germans and Russians are the only white enemies we've had in the last 100 years.
No,
there are Arabs in there.
I played a few games. Arabs are the hardest board. Arabs and Asians are the hardest boards on video games now.
Yeah,
Russians are very easy to beat now.
That's because they have Chinese stars.
Yeah,
and nunchucks.
When are people going to learn though that it does? It's not about Xbox. It's not. Nothing's going to. You know, you can't change racism through. Nothing's going to change until you know
two tin cans and a string.
It's
strung between a black guy and a white guy.
None's going to help.
You're just going to get crap.
The black people got to stop stealing, and gay people have to stop hurting God, and Jews have to stop manipulating the media. And then that you got to get to the root of the problem.
As soon as anybody but black people admit that there's racism or something.
No, it's gonna stop when we're all the same color.
It's like we think racism is the boogeyman or the Loch Ness monster. Nobody white ever
exactly.
says it unless it's a joking manner.
Exactly.
Oh, no, I remember when
Venus and Serena Williams complain that they get racist attitudes thrown at them on tour.
Right.
Like people yell stuff at them during matches and stuff. And so they asked Martina Hingis, the Swiss player.
Mm-hmm.
That's as white as it gets, Swiss.
Of course.
And she said, I'm on the same tour and I don't see the racism. they don't really. They reserve it for the Williams sisters, you idiot.
She's too busy doing drugs.
Those Williams sisters,
just
because they call
right?
you Niglet doesn't mean anything.
Exactly.
All right, let's see what Dr. Phil has to say on the subject. So he did a whole show on this yesterday with the Xbox.
I love playing video games as much as I like eating food. I've been a loyal customer of Xbox Live and Xbox 360. Now, it's gotten worse with the racial slurs, the name-calling, and the bullying online. I've been calling you monkey, or your hands greasy from eating all that chicken. I'm gonna put a lynch on your door, or is that your kids in the background? I've had to stop my children from playing the online games, my 10-year-old daughter, my 13-year-old son, and even my 5-year-old son. And he asks me, Daddy, why I can't play online with you? I want to play that. I go, no. But he goes, why?
They're going to call me names, and I think that's sad for a five-year-old to even know that.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
Why are you kids playing video games, you crappy parent?
Have they
played against... Me and Anthony looking at each other like, whoops.
Have they played against Team Gay?
Sorry.
I didn't mean it.
I think they're talking about you guys.
Yeah, oh, Jesus. Exactly. You're like, oh, that was mine.
Oh, boy.
That greasy chicken there, I didn't know he was black. I thought he was just cooking chicken.
I just thought he played poorly.
Yeah, the control is slipping out of your hand, obviously.
No.
Oh, my God.
It was Erd Lee. I was calling him cheap. Wow. Well, you know what? The internet, that type of thing is just basically a CB radio.
Yeah.
I mean, it's you talking to a bunch of guys. You don't know where they are. And you
can't see them either, so you don't know what color they are or religion or anything like that.
You can't tell by a voice.
Sometimes
you
can't.
When their clan name is DMX.
The last bastion of racism. Boy, y'all are trying to find any way to do it.
I know.
You can't do it out in the open no more.
It's the two. Every time there's a new technology, porn and racism is the biggest thing to come out of it.
Thank God.
White people just trying to find different ways to be racist. It's just bothering.
And you take this away from us.
Think
of
all the technology we have to invent to be more racist.
Right. We're not that good at anything else. We're amazing at that.
What do you mean we're?
I don't understand why you keep grouping yourself in, Spick. You're a red-headed plumber. You're a farmer.
Yeah, but see, that's the thing.
Don't
that's
pick
how
my
great...
spinach. Stop with the weed. You're an albino Mexican.
But that's how powerful whiteness is, that it transcends Mexicanness.
It does purify everything.
It does.
Just good.
You can be born in Africa of African black parents and have be named Mumbamba. If you're white, you know, come on, but join the health club. You know, join the club.
Oh, man.
Get to the front of the bus, my friend. I don't care where you're from.
Black president, no way in hell.
No. You know how many arguments I've had with my girlfriend over racist remarks I make? She can't
really
believe I make them. She's like, would you say that in front of Patrice?
Like, well, yeah, yes. In front of me.
Of course.
Yeah. Not most.
By the way,
Gavin, no.
By the way, she must hate me then.
By the way, what Patrice...
She must hate me.
What Patrice called Louis got dumped. You know, you just can't.
What? Did it really?
Yeah,
it got dumped.
But I was calling Louis that, and he said
it's,
okay.
It's just ridiculous.
That's right. A bad one.
On
that's
behalf
a bad
of all Mexicans,
one.
I accept the phrase. And
yeah, whatever. Let's play no more problem. Dr. Phil audio here.
Only if you put N-span.
I do, though,
it.
Feel for anybody.
Oh, my God. You should be hit with a brick, but that was funny.
At least now everyone knows what the hell we were talking about.
N-span.
All right, listen, here we go. Gamer's wife tells Dr. God. Phil why she is concerned about this racist stuff going on online.
So you're worried that he's going to maybe draw these people into the real world?
I just, you know, Dr. Phil, I just feel like in the internet, in this situation, anything is possible. I don't know who these people are. They're claiming to be the KKK, and I have a real big problem with that. You know, they're calling my children monkeys, that they're going to hang them, they're going to kill them, they're going to kill me. It's crazy, and it's out of control, and nobody is trying to do anything about this.
But it's
my husband has contacted Microsoft for many years, and I don't understand why the FBI is not all over the desk.
FBI. Maybe they should look for, you know, people that want to fly planes into buildings. Leave the FBI alone. They shouldn't be after Xbox. You're talking about the same thing that you get on the computer. Internet cowards, they're called. They just get on there, bash people, they're nameless and faceless, and have no courage to confront anybody. And that's all you're getting. I understand how offensive it is to this woman and her kids and her husband and everything. That's completely understandable. But as far as it actually being a threat, it's not.
I think it is. But they shouldn't have their kids playing the game. I mean, they're exposing their kids to a lot of bad things.
You think the game shouldn't be?
No, it's got nothing to do with the game. Mm-hmm. It's. I mean, make no mistake. It's awful. And disgusting that people go on Xbox and call
and play other races and just stick with our own.
and they go there. They're awful people. But this woman shouldn't have her kid playing it. And it's got nothing to do with Xbox. Again, Xbox is just the street that they met on. It's absurd. Yeah. It's misused energy to fight in that direction, like, oh, we got to go after Xbox. It's got nothing to do with
Xbox. There's so many options on Xbox. About somebody. You can send something directly to Microsoft about a particular person.
You can block them. You can't hear them anymore.
You can mute anybody you want, and you can run your own room and kick anybody you want out of the room. So You know, and there's certain times kids shouldn't play. When we're on,
no kids should play.
Right. They shouldn't be around.
They shouldn't be on.
If you have children and you're letting them play, if you have children and you play and you're letting your kids play Xbox, you should have your children taken
well,
away.
Well, Xbox
Sam,
online.
Your kids should be taken away. From
racism that. On Wii bowling. Anything like that on the Wiimote?
No.
When you use the Wiimote to play Wii bowling with those wobble-headed bobble doll characters,
no, poor
or
thing.
Wii baseball?
No.
Can you make your own bowling ball to look like somebody's face?
Oh, God damn.
All right, listen. Dr. Phil makes the brilliant observation that technology is good and it's bad.
Oh, ooh,
wow, Dr. Phil.
Technology, there's good and bad. I mean, you enjoy playing this game, right? You couldn't do that before the technology existed, but it comes with a downside.
I'm spending thousands of dollars to Microsoft. So I think, and it's coming inside of my house.
Yeah, and so you think they owe you some
time.
Protection?
What?
Right.
All right, you're crazy.
Right. Thousands of
you're
dollars.
You're crazy.
I don't play online. I love artificial intelligence.
Yeah.
I love playing the game. I don't like getting online.
Online
people.
Is great. Yeah.
MySpace people.
Real people.
Say, what's your gamer tag? I don't want to play with you.
No, it's great really playing real people.
Yeah,
it's a lot better. Because you know you're frustrated. When you shoot someone in the face, you know if they're sitting in their house just going, you know, they're so frustrated.
You're playing against
that's usually me.
You're playing against somebody else's like psychology. Like if
that's low
the computer runs around the thing like 8 times. I may run around, stop, and come back and shoot you in the face.
Call of Duty 4, just playing it on hard is not hard enough.
You're just
it's,
pissing
it's
away
like
your brain on that stuff.
Yeah,
it's just the worst thing for a human being.
Actually, I
think, look, for you, you're how old are you now?
I'm in my 40s.
You're just coasting to your death. Nobody, no,
yeah,
fine.
It's true.
There's nothing
might
being
well
wasted.
Have fun.
You've got your career. You make money. You go ahead.
You've learned everything you want to learn.
Yeah.
So
but a for Bob Kelly... You look two bad months and you're homeless. So you're putting your life in danger.
Jesus wow, he just went right out of wow. pockets.
He actually gave you an extra month.
Somebody with Spanish doubloons in their pocket just told you you're broke.
Doubloons. All right, listen. We got two more clips we want to squeeze in here. Gamer afraid that the people threatening him will find out who he is by Googling him, but he's not worried that he's on national TV talking about this. So. Let's listen to this clip.
And your fear is they've said, I'm going to Google you. I'm going to you got a tag that you use when you're playing.
Yeah.
That somehow they can trace that back through, get to your account, find out where you live, and get to you. And that's a possible,
no.
That's a possible thing. I mean, that's a
yes,
real
it is, Dr. Phil.
Right?
My fear is my kids, targeting my kids and... who knows? I don't know. I mean, if people
exactly.
write, I think my rights are violated, especially if you're writing KKK and you're actually taking the time to do all this stuff and
three letters
out stuff and it's just
yeah, it doesn't take much time. It's one key. There it is.
Don't forget caps lock.
I should be able to swim in the Pacific Ocean without sharks attacking me.
Mm-hmm.
I need someone to protect me against these sharks when I get in that water. Why? How about not getting in the water, my friend?
Yeah,
no,
exactly.
I should have the. It's my God-given right.
No,
it isn't.
To get on the internet and play. Shut up.
Game is rated M, also, so the kids shouldn't
no,
be playing it.
All.
Oh
nah.
No! Well, it said rated M.
Let me say this to black people, please. Intellectual black people, stop messing around with dumb white people. That's what I'm really getting tired of.
Yeah.
It's always a retarded white guy, and then black people getting ready to go, well, and then he gets on, and it's a travesty.
Yeah.
It's like, it's these Yahoo white boys
right.
calling you a monkey, and you're bothered by that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go why?
Let's go to Kevin in Connecticut. Kevin.
Yeah, it sounds like you guys need the Malcolm Xbox.
Let's go to Travis from the Bronx. Travis.
Yeah, I play plenty of Call of Duty all the time. I'm black, and all this racism is just nothing. This guy who's complaining about he's a damn wimp. He's a grown man.
Yep.
Come on now. Hmm. I mean, if people are going to talk trash to you, it's all in good fun. They don't really mean to hurt your feelings. If they do,
you know what they're, yo, dude, you know what they're doing all here? Making a monkey face, all of them.
Oh, shut up.
They're all putting their tongue up into their top lip, and they're going,
Jimmy's up on the counter.
Except
Jimmy's swinging from a chandelier and throwing bananas at people.
We were actually trying to make the face.
Yeah.
All right. I thought it, didn't say it. Glad I didn't.
I use the American History Xbox. That's the one I like to use.
Let's go to Mike
excuse me.
In Dallas. Or is this Max? Mike?
Yes, Mike.
What's up,
and,
Mike?
I'm a truck driver, and they do the same thing on the CB. They do all the talking noise. We call them CB Rambos. You know, you can't see who they are, but that's all they do is talk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they did that. I did that coming back from Monterey. My friend had a CB. He goes, watch this. And he goes, is there anywhere a black guy can get breakfast around here? And just,
No.
I mean, nonstop for an hour and a half.
Oh,
the
Jesus.
The best jokes, some of the best jokes I've ever heard. I mean, really good jokes.
No, the
like knock
is,
knock jokes and every, I mean, everything.
I love the fact that he knew. He goes, watch this.
I've done it a few times.
The thing is, if you go out to like real America where real people are, the all humor is racist.
Yeah.
Every single
yeah.
That's all people talk about. It's that bad.
Right.
Like we have a house upstate in Columbia County, which is a very rural part of New York, and my neighbor who's a farmer invited me to watch the Tyson Lennox Lewis fight in his barn. He stole satellite.
Wow.
And so all of my neighbors were all these really nice people. We all went and watched it. And a couple of minutes into the fight, some guy's like, look at them monkeys up there. And they just start.
God.
And I'm sitting there like, I just feel horrible.
And in front of you. And you're like the new guy there?
Yeah, I'm like the New Yorker.
Yeah.
And they're, you know, but they're all, I realize that's all, they sharpen their humor on racism. It's the only thing they have to make fun of.
Wow.
Like, that's all they do.
All right, we got the final clip here from Dr. Phil.
And it's a site on there, a game called Uno. Everybody knows what Uno is. It's actually a live feed.
What?
It's four people. Four people have a camera, and we can see each other as we play the game Uno. Now you have people on there taking off their clothes and perverted things, running around naked.
Nice.
And it's all about the money now. It's so easy to get online now. You can go to your local 7-Eleven, your liquor store. And buy this a month on
the liquor store, the gun store, the KFC.
What the? Come on, dude.
Who's at a local check?
Everybody always says library.
Yeah.
Everybody
goes
to the library. I know. You buy one up a fillet on the corner.
The coffee shop or the library.
Kennedy Fried Chicken.
This guy's no Reverend Al. He's really trying to get something going.
This guy's burying himself.
At least I get my hats.
He stayed on that Uno game long enough to notice that they're getting naked.
They're getting naked.
He should have turned his computer off immediately.
I'm getting Uno.
Here's the second half of the clip.
You can go to your local 7-Eleven, your liquor store, and buy this a month, year subscription for $49. You can buy one for $7.
This is an ad.
Come
for...
home, actually type in the code, and you're online. So who's to say my
he knows
son,
exactly how
my
to do
daughter,
it.
Gets online, plays Uno, and it's a pervert online luring her to go do something. So who's at fault?
Did he say
you? The parents?
Or is it Microsoft? If something happens to my kid?
Oh my God! Shut up!
Blame Microsoft.
Yeah, go ahead.
Good.
How about this? People to get online and stuff like that, you got to use your real name and identity. How about that?
No.
No, why
no.
not?
That ain't going to happen.
Because you'd be arrested. I'd be in jail. No, but I'm saying, like, where else? There are other places.
You know what?
Where else can you interact without any real facial recognition? The internet's a weird place. Like, any other time.
It's also, it's not just, as Patrice deftly put it, retarded white folk. It's also supposedly smart. Like, with the writer's strike, there's, like, this online sort of forum of people talking about it. And they're all, like, writers and, like, you know, millionaires.
Yeah.
Arguing about it. And, like, I went on once and just and questioned something the Writers Guild
oh,
was doing.
Boy.
And they're just like, you piece of... Like, I mean, I never gotten sworn at so much in my life.
Yeah.
And just say, you should have your this and that torn open and just... And these are like guys with jobs
yeah,
and mansions.
All of a sudden
and
they come out.
With anonymous names.
Yeah.
You know, it just says Writer 02. And
that's
just
it is.
Like, you're a yeah. piece of
gold. There's zero accountability.
That's all it is.
Online. And everyone knows that. So you could say whatever you want.
Yeah.
And there's no responsibility. No.
I was in a chat room one time and someone said something I didn't like. And I'm like, oh, jump in a lake.
Hey.
Oh, hey. Watch out.
Easy.
Hey, Jimmy, bring us home. Get everyone's plugs out here, will you?
All right. Well, this week I'm in Pennsylvania. Next week I'm at the Borgata. It's sold out. It's been a great week. Thanks a lot.
No, everybody else.
Oh, sorry. Patrice is going to be tonight and tomorrow at Governor's in Levittown, Long Island. Four shows, two tonight, two tomorrow. Bobby Kelly will be at Caroline's tonight, 10:30, tomorrow, 10:30, Sunday, 8 o'clock. It's 212-757-4100. And Stupid's Comedy Central special comes out January 18th. And Patrice's Def Jam is this Sunday, am I correct? His Def Jam will be on this Sunday night.
On HBO.
On HBO, of course. And young Louis C.K., I don't remember your plug.
February 14th in Buffalo, 15th in Cleveland, 16th Detroit.
Okay.
Miami on Wednesday. Nobody cares.
Okay. And Gavin will be...
What was the word?
Strapping.
No, what was the word Bobby used?
Blasting.
Blasting.
Gavin will be blasting his way all over Manhattan for the next couple of
wrecking
months.
Wrecking sofas all over the city.
We'll be doing pulp of women on sofas.
Oh, Basil Tease, thank you, Tom.
Yes.
For all the great food. Where? Hooper Avenue and Tom's River.
Delicious. Amazing.
Basil Tease Brew Pub and Grill. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Delicious.
All right, we're over, going over to XM. You guys have a great weekend.
Babe.
Talk to you Monday.
This is the Opie and Anthony Show.
Opie and Anthony.
Opie and Anthony.
Opie and Anthony.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show. Thud, thud. Here. Squeaky mic stands. Loud headphones. There we go. Hi.
All right, we made it over to XM Satellite Radio. We got rid of the annoying one. And now we can broadcast.
But wait, I don't see Jimmy here.
No. Talking about Patrice.
Oh.
But Gavin's here to make sure we don't say too many bad things about him.
He'll report back to Patrice.
He sure will. Yeah. We got Club Soda Kenny. He's in the middle of the studio over there. Where's Jimmy?
Probably. What do you look like the announcer for a show over there?
And now.
Yeah, why don't you do the big announcement for the XM show?
Good morning, people.
Why would the mic be on?
You should have a musical that you do. Why would it work?
Yeah, why?
Why would it work?
I try again.
And here's Jimmy.
Look how awful he looks. He's all by himself way over there with his stupid granny glasses
those
on.
Fucking awful glasses.
One chair, one mic in front of him on a mic stand.
Like he's Ed McMahon. Yes.
And now, back to you, Opie.
No, that's not how it goes. You gotta just announce the whole show.
Thank you, Anthony.
No,
not individually. As a collective.
Yes.
Da-da-da-da-da. It's the Opie and Anthony Show. Starring our good friends, Opie and Anthony. And guest star. James Norton.
He's not guest starring.
Jesus Christ.
I'm like fucking Steve Lawrence.
Please just stick to hitting people that are trying to say hi to Jim.
Well, Kenny's here because the dump report.
Yes.
Oh, this is going to be a...
It's going to be a fucking Lulu.
It's going to be longer than the show you just did.
How many dumps did we get on the other side?
10 dumps.
10 dumps.
10?
Wow.
Yes.
Banner day.
9-1, I'm going to say. 9 Louie, 1 Howard.
I didn't say count that many times.
8-2.
Yeah.
One, I'm going to say 8 Lou, 1 Patricky, 1 fucking Howie.
I think I got dumped for, I think I said scumbag.
You got dumped for something you were thinking. That's how strong
you
were.
Yeah, I know. I was really fucking thinking it.
I said shit.
Something so racist that the air goes blank.
It's like, wow, holy shit. Yeah.
I said shit during one of your live reads.
Did you?
Oh, yeah.
I that was like you lost money on that.
Oh, I saw you go like this.
Oh, yeah. My mic wasn't on, but in the background, I was discussing something with Jimmy, and I'm like, yeah, and that fucking shit, and blah, blah, blah. And you're in the middle of doing a live read for Tigers or something.
But. I was like, yeah. The gyms you go to are shit.
I said cunt lips, but they took it in context and left.
So they were going with it.
Oh, thank God for that.
But you're saying how nice cunt lips are.
Yes.
All right, let's play the sweeper. Right. The funny thing about the dump report, Louis's like, I'm trying to be better for you guys. But take note that probably all of these dumps are Louis's.
I know.
Just about.
Live from the Opie and Anthony Show Studios, the Daily Dump Report.
Yeah, Anthony was a good boy. He didn't make the list.
All right.
Neither did I.
I know. Oh, Jimmy didn't either.
Yeah, no, you're professional.
Of course we are.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
First one, 7:15 a.m., Patrice O'Neill, so I can piss.
That's right. Yeah.
That's so dumb.
Can't say piss? No.
8:07,
but piss is
Louis
delicious.
C.K. debuts.
Yeah.
What if you really... No, excuse me. Strike that.
When does he debut?
8:07, Louis C.K. What if you have really sticky poo?
Really?
Yep.
Sticky poo?
You can say poo, you just can't describe the poo.
Because when you're trying to target men 18 to 49, you don't want to describe doo-doo.
They're
going to
call in and say they didn't like
doo-doo.
That truck. I'm a truck driver. I didn't appreciate that sticky poo.
Sticky
poo.
Listen
no more.
That's pretty much the first word kids learn is poo, but we're not allowed to say
there's
it on the radio show.
Every sticky kid says it. Parents refer to their fucking shit as poo. It's not... I would defy... the FCC to fucking actually find someone for saying sticky poo.
Yep. All right.
But
what else?
Cool scary radio. Cats.
And 8:08, Louis backed it up with, things come violently rocking out of our asses.
Rocketing, you motherfucker.
Are they rocking out of your ass, like on a chair?
Rocketing.
Yeah, that's what I said, didn't I?
Rocketing,
yeah,
he said.
That's what I meant.
Yeah, that's funny. Rocking isn't funny.
No.
No.
It means like there's an old lady on a log just fucking back and forth sipping a fucking lemonade.
Trying to smush it down.
8:10, Howie Mandel said, fuck you.
Ooh, Howie. Yeah.
That's gray area.
That's the deal or no deal, Howie Mandel. Yeah.
Said fuck.
8:12, Louis C.K.
Oh, Jesus.
And this is a comment here editorialized in reference to a sheet that was used for sex. Louis C.K. said, one bloody-eyed ghost.
Yeah.
Well. And he never said sex.
No. But I listened to Tom's logic. I know why they dumped it, even though I didn't agree with it. But it was like, I can't kill him for that one. Because he's like, no, the sex, he went through the whole discussion. And it's like, at least they think he wasn't completely like fucking sticky poo. Childish.
Well.
Right.
Tom's a smooth talker, though.
That's going to be my rap name, too. One Bloody-Eyed Ghost.
But he's actually
from the album
collaborating
Sticky
with Sticky Poo. Yeah. Yeah.
But there are times where Tom will go, no, that shouldn't have been dumped. You know, that was one he's like, no, I told him to dump that.
Wow. No, I on that show and with who was in that room and what was being discussed, the dumps... You know, I would chalk that up to like one of those National Guardsmen at Kent State that shot those kids.
Yeah, hey. They were charging.
He put
a
flower in my rifle, and then he threw lit a firecracker. What am I going to do? I shot him. Sorry.
Right.
Tough situation.
Kenny just goes right.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Because Kenny wants to talk some more.
What shitty station is doing this? Hannah Montana contest. Men dress in drag for Hannah Montana tickets. And it's some kind of a goofy, wacky radio.
And you interrupted.
Promotion.
Bob had a doozy. Bob,
sorry.
Go.
Right?
You asshole.
I didn't see you
put a little pressure on what he said.
I had nothing. I just thought of you down there trying to pick somebody up and somebody's stealing your glasses.
That's a great story, man.
That's fantastic.
Give me those, motherfucker.
No, I just took it for wasting my time. Sorry, go ahead, Ken.
Louis again, 812, one pussy bloodied eye ghost.
Very descriptive.
818, very Louis funny, C.K., so. Douchebags.
That's one that never should be dumped.
Never.
Right. Never, that's not your fault.
836, Louis C.K.
Mr. Common Denominator.
Referencing Bob Kelly's Call of Duty 4 team gay, Louis C.K. said, faggot.
Never should be dumped.
Never should be dumped.
Never should
you should never call us faggots either. We're gays.
Every time I clear my throat to talk, they put their finger on the button.
They never should have been dumped. That's just fucking pussy thinking.
Yeah, faggot thinking.
Yeah, hey, man.
840, Patrice Spick.
Oh, boy.
Another one that should not have been done.
No.
Tom didn't know you were Mexican. And right. It's like, it shouldn't matter, but that's the way they think over them. Like, dude, it was a racial discussion. They're parodying racism. Stop it.
So if there's a spick in the room, you can say spick?
That's the mentality. What do you expect? It's all white guys running things. That's
they're doing doors. I am a spick, and I approve of this message. They need that.
You have to say it like I approve of this message.
I approve of this message, senor. Does anyone really talk like that?
Not a single Mexican in the world.
I love that. Yes, senor.
Si, senor.
Si.
I got boogies in my nose.
Do you want a drum roll for the last one since we're supposed to do sound effects?
We're not supposed to do sound effects over here.
No, I know.
What was it?
I know. Last one, 846, Louis C.K., pissing away your brains.
What?
But that isn't
that's not about the frothy yellow drink Jimmy's staple.
Pissing away your time or pissing away.
Pissing away is
give
a
me
verb.
A break.
Fucking once. I mean, right. Look.
Context, assholes.
That's
context.
The dump guys, like, I know it's a tough gig,
but
he has got to learn.
That's ridiculous.
That's ridiculous. Yep.
Pissing away your brain.
Everyone
and I'm talking
knows.
About people shouldn't have their kids use Xboxes.
That's exactly like
because
you say,
they're pissing away their brain, and that's they dump that.
Come on, dude.
It's the same context as saying, don't give me that crap. You know, I don't have to take any crap from her, or she crapped on my face.
Yep.
You can't say she crapped on my face, but you could say, don't take any
but
more crap.
But pissing away isn't even actually referring to the bathroom.
At all.
Yeah.
It's actually using the verb, like, as if you could piss, money. I mean, it doesn't make sense.
Yeah. You could say pissed off. I was so pissed off yesterday. You could say that.
I've never heard
they don't
of that
dump
being dumped anywhere, pissing away your...
No, it shouldn't be dumped anywhere.
That's,
it's fucking revolting.
Maybe he thought the brain could actually work its way into the bladder.
Right, and then come out as piss.
And you were pissing... You know,
just
talking about
saw
the
brain tissue coming out of the tip of my cock.
Yeah. You just saw your
mixing with the shit
button.
And semen that
your
I just
big red
put
bush,
on a hole in a sheath,
your freckled cock.
Exactly,
that just disturbed him.
That's right. Look, I get it.
Well, you tried though today, Louis. That's
well, I know,
thing.
Man.
That's
it's bad. It's bad. I hurt. So I'm hurting you guys.
No, there's a few that you shouldn't have done. On,
no, but it's a it's a critical mass issue.
And
like if you're giving me,
XM
it's
heard
like
it.
When a guy gets mad at the ump for punching him out. You swung at strikes one and two. So you can't, you put, you said, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I can't, you know, I said cunt and nigger about five times. So sure, when I said piss, the guy started
and you can't
me.
Go like, ah, you know.
Yeah, come on!
Come on!
Come on!
I'm just watching Gavin, making sure he doesn't get pissed at you. You spit out nigger with the extra nigger.
And then you did it twice.
Well, yeah, I said, yeah, it, I said it in go. A kooky way.
I don't think you said it in a kooky
he's
way.
Not black? Is he black? Black?
Yeah, not black that, off, nigger.
Half black, half white.
Half yeah. black, yeah. half white. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So are
that
we all.
That makes you black.
So are we all.
The noise of the oppressors.
Census Bureau.
The eyes of the Census Bureau.
But I'm saying, they would count as black.
Sure.
All right.
I get Jimmy. Does that count as black?
We have I'm saying they do. They count.
Government allows you that.
What's that?
It's a little different over here.
We got another song from Val Kilmer, everyone.
Oh.
This guy's good, man.
Do we have the one from yesterday to play for the guys?
Oh, we got
to
hear the beginning of
just
that one,
Val
at least.
Kilmer?
He's a good singer.
Val Kilmer is going into music. He's singing.
Jesus.
He does a Neil Young cover.
Hey, can I have another water bottle, please? There's a fucking layer of film on my water bottle.
Ugh.
I just want a non-filmy water.
What do you mean?
Well, you got to be specific when you ask
what do you
for
mean
water.
Film?
Yeah. Touch it.
Can I get a water?
I'm drinking out of it. Touch it. With your,
oh,
just touch it.
Well,
it's from,
yeah,
it's,
angry
it's
Jimmy
from you peeling the sticker off. No, it's not. The sticker doesn't go to the bottom of the bottle, you fucking hump. I know where a sticker goes. I peel the sticker off so I can hold this.
Yeah,
it's all
right.
Cloudy
yeah.
feeling.
Bob's trying to back you up, but he can't. He
tell
can't
these
peel
people
it.
That fucking work with us that fucking Norton gets a non-cloudy bottle.
Jesus.
Are you guys?
He's an angry man today.
Fucking diva.
I'm overtired.
Kenny's running somewhere to get a napkin and a new bottle of water.
I'll do it.
I need water without film.
I stayed up last night.
He doesn't like the film this time.
Jerking a limp cock.
Oh,
just off. Oh, it was awful. The head's just bouncing around stupidly. What do you want from me?
Your cock is like, give me a second.
Thanks.
Jesus.
Let me check it for you before
it's
you come.
I can feel it. Yeah, you can drink that one.
I don't want that. Stop angrily
exactly.
putting the water down.
There's a fine line between the time you can jack off and when your arm gets tired.
Yeah.
There's a fine line.
Now, when you've
there.
Jacked your cock until there's so many raw spots on it,
yeah.
you got to kind of grab it awkwardly.
Yeah. And you have to actually put your finger in the,
yeah.
in the hole and hook it.
Yeah, just every fucking, because there's so many stingy red spots on it. Way too much. Fucking. So it fucking starts bleeding and you use that for a loop.
I actually I jerk off with my left hand, and ever since I got
yeah.
married,
what?
I just feel uncomfortable because my wedding
ring. Are you
ring,
left-handed?
I have to take my wedding ring off now, and
really?
It just makes me feel bad.
Are you a lefty?
Yeah, I'm
a
lefty. I write with my right hand, but I jerk off with my left.
Yeah, what a fucking creep. Why? Is that
I'm a creep?
Yes.
Why?
Why is that creepy? Jerk off with your left hand? Who does that?
I'm of the same school, Bob.
You jerk off with your left hand?
You can't do it. It's not. You don't have the coordination.
No, not
it goes all
they're
all over the place.
Her own hand does the same thing.
Yeah,
it's a sign of intelligence.
I
no.
write righty, and I'm very awkward.
Yeah, it's too hand. Awkward.
Yeah.
What left hand reversal?
Oof.
Now you're talking.
Nice, whoa. Right?
No, it's
yeah.
like how left-handed people.
Your balls.
When left-handed people write, they write from above the words. You know,
oh, it looks ridiculous. When left-handed people write.
Annoying.
Yeah.
This
is like, wrong.
Hand
this
is wrapped
wrong.
Around like a cobra.
It's like right backwards. Yeah. Yes,
I think a little, looks like a little.
That must be what it's like when they jerk off. Like you got to
yeah.
go around
yeah,
like as if trying to pretend it's a right hand.
They come first, then have to like put the semen back in the dick, fucking smudging over everything. Fucking hate lefties.
Time for some Val Kilmer. So,
wrong with you?
Hey,
you know, got,
yeah. So Val Kilmer, he wants to be a musician,
right?
He's good, man.
He's got like five or six songs on his MySpace.
Not.
Yeah. And he's trying to get a record deal. And what I'm about to play is a piece of "After the Gold Rush," the famous Neil Young song
that he re-recorded.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
But then we got a brand new one for everybody. We got a brand new
cool,
Val
man.
Kilmer song. But listen
excellent.
To a piece of this.
What?
That's the remix. The original is in the Master Computer. I'm sorry. Eric just told me to tell you that. Is that what
oh,
you just said?
Boy. Oh, boy.
What, so this is a remix, meaning you guys remixed
oh,
it? Or
yeah. No.
What, this is the super mix?
Yes.
I oh, don't God. Want the super mix.
Why would I want that?
We want the...
You need
oh,
a straight line first.
E-Rock.
What did E-Rock do?
Oh, E-Rock.
Hold on, let's give him the benefit of the doubt. E-Rock, what'd you do?
Here, he's running in.
Let's ask him. He might have... We can't just throw E-Rock under the bus.
Sure no, the can. Originals were set up like Oak wanted, and I gave Than the remix and said in case he wants that one too. And
where's the original?
The original is.
Yeah, we just want the original today. All right, whatever.
All right. Now go do all the exercise you'll do for the next month by running out there and grabbing it.
Congrats. You almost did something right today.
Sorry, that was a cheap shot.
Oh, very close to right.
I try to go to bat for Eric. I hate him.
I'm going to bother at this point.
All right, hey. So here's Val Kilmer doing Neil Young's After the Gold Rush.
Saw the knight in armor come.
The fuck?
Yes. Something the Indian from Natural Born Killers.
Is he kidding?
No.
No, that's just that sincere?
Yeah,
it gets better, though. Split the tree.
There was a fanfare. Oh, my God.
Oh,
this
wow.
is horrible.
Is this real?
Sun oh, my God. It was floating
on the breeze. That's right.
Look at Mother Nature on the run in the 21st century.
Oh, God, kill yourself. Has to update it.
Right, right.
Look at Mother Nature
she got it, Val.
On the run in the 21st century.
What an asshole.
I've actually heard fucking women queef songs.
Jeez.
Sounded better than this.
Fucking makes fucking Dane Cook sound like an actor singer.
Oh, oh, yeah.
Hey, don't you talk about my boss like
that's
that.
Right. Hold sure on. His driver's going to take issue
sure
with you.
I'm not driving anymore.
The guy who checks him into his hotel is going to get mad.
Torgasm 2 might be happening, so we're going to keep low on this one.
Oh, really?
No, you asshole. I'm kidding.
Why would you say no? That was a massive success.
Yeah, it was.
No, it wasn't.
For him.
It was horrible. Nobody watched it. It was terrible. I know. It was after my show. I saw the ratings every week.
Oh,
less
oh.
people watched every week. Anyway,
oh, it was
anyway,
a,
but Val Kilmer.
Wait a minute, wait a minute.
Val, no, we're talking about
wait
Val Kilmer.
Wait a minute, Lou.
Hold on.
I'd love to defend it, but I really can't. I was on a show with Jay Davis.
You were great on that show, there's no doubt. Oh. But the show was not successful. It was a disaster.
No. But then you lucky didn't get have a lot of viewers.
I didn't
What's
get
that?
Fucking they dumped
No, we
us
had
too.
A lot of viewers. That's exactly right.
That life sucks.
I didn't make yeah. it. I got 2 points on the DVD, and I was actually hoping that he might sell a lot of DVDs, and it didn't. My lawyer called, and he, the lawyer. My lawyer's Chunk from the Goonies.
Yeah, he's a lawyer now, and he's the same lawyer.
But he's just ridiculous. He's like an aggressive lawyer. He's just an ass. And I was like, this guy's going to get me some money. He called back, nothing. You made nothing. They sold nothing.
No.
Nothing.
Not no, we used to get the ratings every week, and they'd show us the whole HBO lineup. It would be Entourage, and then us, and then Torgasm. And we were ticking up every week a little bit, but Torgasm was dumping really hard. Like, there was one point where Torgasm would go down, and then a shitty, like, movie from, like, with whoever in it.
Jan Michael Vincent?
Yeah, like a Jan Michael Vincent movie that it came on after at, like, 12 midnight would go up. From what Torgasm was
getting. Oh, wow. Yeah.
Zero people watched.
That's not good.
Yeah. No, it was a very poorly done show.
Why don't we fucking...
But Bob, I used to watch it because I liked... But I didn't really know
what
you that
Dennis
well.
Dennis Hopper want?
And I got to like you from watching you on that show. You came out well.
Yeah.
You acquitted yourself nicely. on that show. But...
Hold on. What is fucking...
What's going on?
What is Barry Slotnick? What fucking doing?
What is going on?
I don't know what he is.
Pointing and
it's like a zoo.
Looking at stuff.
What are those people doing?
Who is that creep?
Ridiculous.
They're looking at him.
Hey, hold on. I want to know
they're
what fucking...
They're building something out there.
Hey, what does the father from Family Ties want in this studio? Why is my Republican son shaking all over the place? Who is this creep? What does he want?
No, enough.
So we got a little earpiece.
We get it.
Too.
We got today's Val Kilmer song. It's fucking perfect.
It's a new
Val
one. Kilmer, Jesus.
That's great, right?
I have a weird story about Val Kilmer, and I'm not sure I should tell it, but I'm going to anyway.
Tell it. We love you.
Because it's kind of private. But Chris Rock told me that he got a call once from Val Kilmer, got his number through channels, of famous people channels.
Yeah.
He doesn't know.
Both are.
And he called him and left a message like, hey, man, let's hang out sometime. I want to know if you want to hang out and go to a game or something like that. And Chris was like, I don't fucking... Do you think just because we were both in movies once, you can just call me and I'll hang out with you? Like, I guess celebrities do that. But for some reason, that instance of it really rubbed him wrong. That it's Val Kilmer thinks... Like, he's the president. Like, he can just get folks on the phone and hang out with them. Like, he was watching Chris on TV and thought, yeah, I'm going to go to the game with that guy tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'm Val Kilmer.
We both work in the same industry.
Yeah, very
vaguely. It's like a steel worker just calling another steel worker and going, hey, you want to hang out?
Let's go to the bar.
What are you doing?
Yeah, but you got to love, like, Chris, like, Chris's, on, like, his immediate honesty. My response time is like 3 days later.
Right.
I'd be in the movie theater or hanging out with this jackass, you know, uncomfortable.
Why am I here?
Yeah, and then I'd be home having the argument by myself. Dude, yeah. Val.
First of all, don't.
Val,
no, Chris
don't
is Chris is a very.
Don't even try to say you wouldn't fucking latch on a Val Kilmer's dick.
Yeah,
in a minute.
That's exactly what I said. That I would.
In a minute.
You said your response time is 3 days later. You would be saying, "Why am I hanging out with Val?" You'd be like, "Val, the new Val Kilmer on your phone."
I would
be playing Call of Duty 4.
What? Chris is a very real guy, and I was with Chris once in an Aspen for the comedy festival, and some people grabbed us, some promotion people. Me and Chris were just out on the street in Aspen, and they kind of corralled us into this designer store, this really really expensive like $600 shirt store, and they said, take whatever you want, like, because they wanted Chris to wear their
stuff. Yeah, wow. Yeah.
And I'm standing with them, so they said it to both of us.
Nice.
Take whatever you want. And Chris is a very classy guy, so he was like, you know what, give me a t-shirt. I don't, like, he just doesn't want to take. He doesn't want to be a pig. He goes, just give me a t-shirt. I don't want to take this nice stuff.
What did Joey Louie do?
I made them fucking unpadlock a leather jacket, and I took it. I'm like, give me that jacket.
Oh, wow.
Nice. And the woman, like, this British woman, she's like, okay. And
she didn't want to.
No, she did not want to
Good
at all.
For her.
And I'm like, because he's like, he's in a place like that every day, and he has discretion. But I'm like, I may never have this opportunity again. I'm like, give me a leather jacket. They have to take the alarm off. They had to disarm the alarm.
How much was
the leather jacket?
Oh, that thing had to be ridiculous.
It's the greatest jacket in the world.
How much do you think it's worth? Gotta be
that jacket. What?
Okay. No, perhaps more than that, Jim.
Perhaps, probably like at least $2,500, I think.
When we were doing the Vegas Comedy Festival with Dane, they promised, because we were with Dane and we went to this, we were supposed to go to this party, we were going to get free Sony Vios. Me, Gary,
and
Dane.
We got those from that. Yeah.
You got
them?
But Dane was like, we weren't going to make the flight or the party. And he was like, you know, what are we going to do?
It was a
vodka
party.
The only thing in my head was like, I got to get to Vegas. I need my free computer.
Yeah.
I got the free computer.
I got it too.
And it's sitting in my closet.
But I had a really
I'm a piece of shit because my dad's pretty poor. Like, he doesn't make a lot of money. And I said to him, because I got that Vio, and I am a Mac guy, I have no use for it. And I said, I have a new Vio, do you want it? And he's like, that would really be a big help to me. And I just haven't sent
it.
Shit. It's sitting there, no one's using it.
Oh, such a great computer.
My own father, it isn't even like I could donate it to a school, actually, and like help kids. My own father, who like works for very little money.
It's just sitting
I'm
there.
I'm like, Dad, shit. Yeah, I'll send it.
How
Sorry.
Could you not help the man that blasted a load into your mother while she was sleeping?
In Mexico.
Because he's Mexican. Because he's a filthy Mexican. He doesn't deserve anything.
All right. Hey,
go back to Mexico and get a computer. Go back to Mexico and invent a computer out of beans, you fucking smelly spick.
Beans. Why do you need it? You're not going to be able to plug it in.
I know.
You live in a hut.
Yeah, exactly. What are you going to power it with your fucking Mexican?
To get to the next line, you have to hit
make
the
a battery.
Key.
Yeah.
A dirt key.
You're only going to use it to fucking, you know, cross the border with somehow.
That's true. You got to close the case over yourself and hide it.
You're going to use it as a hat to block the sun in the fields.
Open it like a heavy V. Put it on your stupid non-thinking head.
Oh, my God.
Oh, Christ.
Are we ready for the Val Kilmer
song?
Oh,
I forgot.
There's another one, right?
Terrific.
New one.
Today's song is called Hold On to Daddy. Oh, him with the daddy.
I like that. I think that's nice. He's got a thing
with
his
daddy.
Yeah.
When I'm gone, I say hold on to daddy.
Where did he sing this?
I know.
Larry Craig sitting there tapping his foot
in the shower.
Wow. He's got a studio on the back of a flatbed. What a fucking asshole.
Jesus Christ.
He's horrid.
He's just not there, is he?
Hey, the recording studio's not good. Where would you like to work? Do you have a room with aluminum and tin all over the walls? That would be perfect.
Because you're going to cry. You're going to cry.
What's he doing?
I don't know. When I'm gone.
When I'm gone. I wish you were gone.
Yeah. When I'm gone. When I'm gone. You're gonna cry.
I think she's
cry
so
when you sing.
He's very bluesy. Okay, this guy's got some soul, man.
Doesn't
like it. What? Yeah.
In the freedom. The soul of a Doc Martin put against his head.
You're gonna cry. You're gonna cry. Daddy's gone.
That's right.
Daddy's gone.
Yeah.
I get it.
You're coughing.
Just coughing. This there couldn't be real.
Was there coughing in this?
This has to be a goof.
He's coughing. Jesus. Sounds like someone's trying to take the guitar away from him. There's a fight going on.
Turn your back and watch the sun go down.
What?
You gonna turn your back and watch the sun go down?
How? My God.
Coast West. Priest.
You're not saying anything.
Is he asleep on the mic?
Right, we get it. All right, talking about daddy again, would you?
Yeah, yeah, just keep cranking them out there, you fuck. Fucking asshole.
What happened to the Iceman?
I used to like him, and now fucking hope his kids get a blood disease. Need a transfusion, and it gives them AIDS on top. Fucking asshole.
You do not like him at all.
Yeah. Bad music. None more insulting than bad music. That makes you mad.
Kids got sickle cell.
It really does make you angry.
Yeah, it does.
I think
especially a famous guy going, no, this is good. I'm putting this out there.
Yeah, he's not kidding.
Is he really serious, dude?
He's crazy. Really to be I've a Jim Morrison back in the day.
I've seen him on interviews and stuff on late night talk shows and stuff, and he's like crazy.
Okay. Yeah.
He's a hard interview. Like the people.
The
are
thing
struggling.
That people don't get is that actors are jocks. They're not.
Yes, they are.
They play interesting people, and you attribute that interestingness to them.
Yeah,
they're not. They're jocks. They're people that have this weird rubber ability with their face and their voice, and they're not. They're just sieves, and you can get them to do shit. But then you listen to them talk. This guy's a fucking idiot.
And there's nothing there.
Yeah, they're just dippy, stupid, flaky assholes.
But they can act like real cool people.
They can act like real
substance to prevent them from being someone else.
That's right. Can't you just act like that all the time?
You think, well, because they actually, well, like watch Actors Studio when they're talking, like they let their hair down amongst each other. And you just want to drop a bomb on the entire building. And nothing bad would come of it. Shitheads.
I feel bad for his wife having to lie to him every day.
It's great, honey.
It's great.
Well, she probably thinks it is great. If he's that much of an asshole that he's saying that, his wife's a stupid cunt. Just by deduction, I can just tell you by the transitive law that his wife is a retarded cunt with shit ears. Fucking married that faggot, you stupid cunt.
Jesus.
Bad music. That makes you madder.
It does make you mad.
Oh. He's not
completely angry.
Yeah, that's what I think when I hear a bad song is whoever's singing this, his wife is a cunt. And his kids deserve to die.
We're going to take our first break on XM. Don't forget Bob Kelly's at Caroline's all weekend long.
212-757-4100. But Bob's got an odd schedule. Tonight at 10:30, Saturday, 10:30, Sunday, 8 p.m.
That's it, Jimmy.
Oh, okay.
And
Louie's going to be in Buffalo, Cleveland, and Detroit in the near
future.
Starting
February 14th.
14th, 15th,
website?
And
16th. Yep. Website for these dates.
LouisCK.com. I'm all over the... I'm on tour heavily.
He's on MySpace, too, every day.
MySpace
on the front cover.
/ LouisCK.
And what about Gavin? Where are you going to be?
Just walking around Manhattan.
You're going to be blasting chicks or what?
Blasting white girls.
I'm in Miami on Wednesday. I keep forgetting to say that.
Hey, you know what?
Knoxville, Louisville.
Okay, that brings up something because we had to keep it clean on the other side. So you got to retell that story now that we're on this side, what you were hearing and shit.
Oh, the other room?
Yeah, so it's your wife's best friend from
Boston.
Well,
she was on the rag, too, which is disgusting.
I'm glad you missed that bit out.
Oh, he just fucking blasted her with a bloody white girl pussy.
So what? This is a long time ago, man.
Wait, your wife's best friend comes down from Boston?
Wife's best friend comes down from Boston. She's, you know, she's...
A little innocent?
Leaving a trail of blood.
She looks like Rhoda.
She looks like Rhoda.
You know, and she comes down and... Apparently, she likes the black dudes.
Yeah?
Yeah, she's got a hunkering for a big black cock.
It's a hankering, dummy.
Yeah, exactly.
A hunkering.
I like hunkering, though. I could relate to that.
Thanks, Hope. I was actually...
It's mispronunciation Friday?
Actually,
it
is. Yeah.
Yes. So it's also Point and Laugh Friday.
Go fuck yourself, Air Supply. You do look like the lead singer.
What? Oh, my God.
Are you kidding me?
I don't know what the lead singer of Air Supply looks like.
You look like him now.
No, he doesn't. He's fucking Chef from Apocalypse Now.
Yeah. I'm a saucier.
So
I want to see you grab his head off.
Never get out of the fucking boat.
fucking Kurtz joke.
Yeah, I like fantastic. It.
So,
so he's
good. You combined two people.
That was brilliant. So Gav used to come over my place when he first came over from England. He would come over and hang out. Like we'd play video games all day. Because, I had the Xbox
Live. You're
veering
off the interesting part of the story.
Of course.
Well, he would come over, and I'd be like, all right, man, it's time to go. And he'd be like, all right, mate.
Literally?
I'd be like, I got to go to sleep. And he'd be like, all right, go ahead, man. I'm going to hang out, and I'll play video games.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
And I'd be in my room playing video games. And he came over for like 2 weeks straight. He was at my house. My girl, at the beginning of it, was like, hey, what's up, Gav? At the end of it, he was like... Hey, Gav. And then she actually would cook dinner, and she cooked a whole pork roast. And we had like, I had one slice, she had one slice, Gav had one slice. It was so good that Gav goes, are you guys done? Are you finished? And we're like, yeah, that's it. And he just grabbed, stuck his fork in the rest of the pork roast and put it on his plate. Not joking. Ate almost a whole pork roast by himself.
Wow.
And so my girlfriend's girl comes over and...
First of all, don't try to make it sound like you had some little sliver off the fucking piece.
Exactly.
I'm sure you had a nice chunk.
Exactly. He bought actually bit into it while it was still living.
I actually fought Gavin for it. I took a beating for a pork roast. I sucked his cock for a pork roast.
In the sauna.
So, easy. In the sauna. We worked out together.
You suck his cock for a pork rind.
We're in the sauna, and he takes all his clothes off. It's like a two-person sauna in my building. And he's one and a half. He's a big guy. How tall are you? 6'5", 209,000 pounds. And we're in there. I have my shorts on, and I took my shirt off. I think I even kept my sneakers and socks on. I just went in just to get a quick steam. He comes in.
Who
sauna.
Comes in a steam room with sneakers?
Exactly.
A sauna. It was a sauna. Okay. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's much
and
better.
He comes in and just takes everything off.
That's right. That's what you do in saunas. You're
no,
naked.
You don't. In England, you do. In America,
you
don't.
In Europe, you don't either. In Europe, you're just naked.
Can you get into the English black guy fucking the girl's bloody cunt?
My God. Really? Exactly.
You forgot to mention how much time he had on his Metro card. Fucking get to the cunt fucking.
I like the sauna story.
Ruined.
That was Anthony brought up the.
I want to hear how it sounded like he was jumping up and down in cherry tomatoes.
So they meet up and we all have fun or whatever. We do some horse shit. And then later that night, she's staying at the house. So Gav's staying there too, apparently. And I've never had
holy
a friend
shit.
Stave over since I was in like fucking high school.
How can you stave over? That's not a word.
Are you gonna be on everything? Jesus Christ!
What happened to your storytelling abilities?
I'm a little nervous.
Jesus, you're running.
Get to the fucking
exactly.
Shut your face.
So what happened? She's staving.
Shut
she's
up! Put your
over.
Hands down. First right. of all, I don't like it.
Why?
I just don't like your little thin fingers pointing in my face.
Anything's thin compared to your face.
That was a fucking softball.
No, it was.
So to your head.
I don't like your. I don't like that thin redwood pointing at me.
I'm with Bob, though. We're getting to know what Gavin's all about.
Oh, I don't know. Because,
you know, there's something going on with this guy.
Yes, he's a fucking uncut pork fucking eating monster.
Chicks.
How Bob and his girl are kissing, and they hear he's caving my pussy in. Being screamed from the living room. But he keeps going, I think I had Xbox. Wait, are we playing Grand Theft? Get the fucking Gavin killing her with his big cock.
This is like somebody who's like Leon Zabruder talking about the day Kennedy was shot.
Or Abraham
like,
Zabruder.
Leon Zabruder. He had a brother, Leon.
Over everybody. No, Jesus Christ.
Yes. No, it's like
and then fucking Abraham Klinghoffer that pushed off the
what
long.
The fuck are you, a computer? Relax. Let people fuck up and be human.
Leon fucking Zabruder. Oh, yeah, he shot Pete Kennedy in the head. Shut the fuck up.
I'm trying to stick up for you.
You're right.
Molly Osmond shot.
Fucking Norton's on fire.
Jack Ruby Red Grapefruit. Fucking idiot.
Wow. Leon Zabruder, why did I say that?
Wow, fucking Jesus.
What about this? What about,
I don't want to go forward up. What the fuck? You're pushing me into the fucking line of fire.
Let's go. Let's go.
Nothing good's going to happen.
This is taking way too long. Cocksuckers to
oh, I know.
So,
get fucking devastation.
Let me just take a breath so I make sure I say things correctly.
Hey, Larry
so fucking know that won't fucking grab me. Go ahead. Fucking.
All right. Story.
Hey, Biggie. So we come back to the house and they're on the we're like, you know, it comes to that point where it's like, okay, Gav is gonna either gonna go home or, you know, we're going to bed. Okay, we'll see you guys later, and they're on the couch still. So we go in the bedroom, we're lying there, I got the two dogs. The dogs were scared.
Calby was licking my feet.
It smelled like fucking roast beef. He was just licking blood. Oh, off the couch. So we're in the bed, and you hear the kid that the first kissing that. you fucking. And then you just hear fucking. The couch just like it was wood. You didn't hear it wasn't even metal. He was actually getting into the wood of the couch. Like, you know, you hear the springs in the couch.
Yeah.
You hear the wood just going
like a ship in heavy seas.
Oh, yeah, it was the black pearl. but she, just to let you know, this girl weighs probably 85 pounds.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah. She looked like she had AIDS. Like, that's how thin she was. She was a thin, thin girl. And this fucking monster.
Just under 300.
Oh, just plowing her.
Being her chiropractor.
He did the equivalent of kicking her cunt in with a metal boot.
The equivalent.
But she actually told Dawn, my girl actually said to me, the reason why I know she was on the period, because I was like, do you think they're going to, we're in the room like, do you think they're going to fuck? And she's like, no, she's on the period. She said she wasn't going to do anything. Sure. But this fucking monster just plucked that tampon out like a fucking, a pear off a tree. Threw it against my wall.
He made tea for count. There you go.
Sip this. Straighten out her scoliosis.
Oh, God. Oh. That's nice. Took the curl out of her fallopian tube.
he smoothed out all the bumpy parts of her pussy. Oh, what the hell was that?
Oh, I'll tell you what it was.
Oh.
Sorry.
All right, there you go.
And then,
well, hold on. So you guys.
And
know
then he just left her.
Your friend is fucking
just
gone.
Just left
friend.
Her.
Yeah, you left.
Of course, I just left. What do you do? Kiss and cuddle and fucking.
Then you went to Boston and fucked her one more time.
Yeah,
didn't you?
I did. Yeah.
But she fell in love with him. Great. She was in Gavin.
Really,
was
she likes the cock. Huh?
She was the fuck, you know.
Well, she usually dates gangster American black guys, which is totally different than this fucking suave English
douche. You know,
I was using all kinds of slang.
This is the lethal.
Oh, this
he's black, but he's really light skinned,
right? And with the accent,
and he's got an accent,
right.
And he's made of pure. He's pure animal. He's like tiger. He's like that tiger that killed a kid in San Diego.
That's right.
Like, you know, there's a woman. Fucking masturbating to that in the food court.
Oh, his little smooth accent. So we, Tracy.
I'm black, but it's all right. Listen to me.
It's all right. I like white girls too, you know.
Next thing you know, he's fucking her with his fucking hand over her face like Chief when he's killing Nicholson.
Yeah, she was pretty. She was weird, wasn't she?
Well, yeah. She actually hooked up with this guy, black
crazy
dude.
Thing is, black this, guy. Woman, this woman exists. She's out somewhere. And we're telling this story about her.
Well, this is a few years ago now. It's going back a few years. Oh, okay. It's not recently.
She's got a whole other life now.
Yeah, she's moved on.
Well, she moved on to another black guy who was actually turned out to be a pimp and threw in a trunk and locked her in there and drove around the city for like 4 hours.
True?
Yeah, trunk.
Hey, look, you she fucking did? Pick up a scorpion, you're going to get bit.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to break. Get into some smoothies.
He said, because I'm an alligator. story right. Tells a lot.
Get us out of here for a bit.
I know I speak like an idiot.
Do you? It's all about me.
Is it?
I was assaulted.
Were you?
We're brilliant broadcasters.
Are we?
You are out of your mind.
Am I?
That sounds real good.
Does it?
I'm thrilled. I'm excited.
Am I?
I thought I heard Negro.
Did you?
It's the OB and Anthony Show.
Is it?
It's the Opie and Anthony Show. A very busy Opie and Anthony Show today. I guess. Anthony's getting ready for his big weekend.
That's right, damn it.
On the private jet to Mohegan Sun. Wing on over to Mohegan Sun and gamble with the engines.
It's going to be great.
Yep. Oh, yeah, I ran into a guy last night who... you're going with what's his name that works here sometimes?
Keith?
The guy, is that his name?
Yeah,
looks kind of like Otto Peterson a little
Keith
bit.
The cop.
Wow, good call.
Doesn't he?
He does. Yeah, yes. A little bit. Otto, if he had said no back in like 1974,
right.
To that first line that was offered to him,
exactly.
Long way to go for nothing.
Yeah, I wasn't sure. I was at the olive tree with my I was with my daughter, my 2-year-old, and he walked up with another with a uniform cop.
Yeah,
and I wasn't exactly sure. Like, I've seen him on the tour mostly. I don't know him that well. And he went, hey, what's up? And when I'm with my daughter, I really want people to stay the fuck away from me. Like, I'm very protective.
Right.
You just have a different... So he's like, hey, and he's looking at her, hey! I'm like, get the fuck... Like, I think I might have been shitty to him. I hope I wasn't.
He's an NYPD lieutenant.
Yeah.
I think he's okay.
I know, but cops run amongst filth, you know, like...
That's true.
You know, they put it in jail, but still, you don't want them to touch your daughter after fucking...
A dirty fucking tranny finger.
Yeah,
exactly. Fucking, you got a point there.
Pushing some crackhead's head down into a cruiser. Yeah. And now that
a
hand
is... on his hand.
Yeah. Yeah. Now he's touching
your little
my
kid's head.
Yeah, give her head a tussle or hair.
Exactly.
Yeah, he's going. Him and his wife, me, my girl, and my mother and Sal. Sal's just been calling every day.
He's excited.
So
huh?
We're going. It's almost Friday, Anthony. This is going to be a lot of fun. So what? You got a suites and the plane and the limo?
It's from Baltimore.
So it's
Baltimore?
Just like, oh.
Row! We're gonna go, row! Pack, what kind of clothes am I gonna need? He's like asking me things. I go, I don't know. Just bring some, bring gambling clothes.
He's excited, Anthony.
He's so excited. He's like a little kid.
Take care of him. He's a good man.
We're going on a plane.
And, so.
Private jet back and forth.
We're doing that. They hooked us up with,
You'll have some stories on Monday.
And
if you're here on Monday.
I went to the safety deposit box.
Had
to go to the box. Yeah, I was in there a while.
What are you keeping your box in your safety deposit to keep
cash?
But isn't that stupid?
No.
I mean, isn't that not collecting interest or something?
Yeah, but it's a different account that I have. It's called a collect either a lot of interest by winning
or really losing a lot of it. It's my gambling money.
Oh, okay. So you just want fast access.
I just, poof, yeah, yeah.
Right.
I like being able to keep tabs on my win-loss record.
Okay.
So it all goes in the box. And then when I go, I take it out of the box. And hopefully when I come home, I get to put some back into the box.
Or two boxes.
And that's how it goes. Oh, you're two boxes.
Well,
I would love to have to ask for a bigger box.
How much is in that box at a given time?
We'd have to shut the mics off again.
But isn't it stupid? But isn't it dumb to have cash? Doesn't cash just sit there and not collect?
Hold on. He'll explain everything.
Yeah,
he'll turn off all the mics.
I guess. Actually, that financially makes a lot of sense.
I love how sound thinking. The story always ends up like that, where it's like, we go away.
You turn everybody around.
There's a complete lack of understanding before the mics are on. And then when the mics come back on, it's like, oh, Jesus Christ, of course.
Oh, yeah.
You'd be a great politician.
What kind of shitty advice is that from Louis anyway? He's gambling. Yeah. Why don't you buy treasury bonds? Fucking goody two-shoes.
I have nothing in the bank anywhere, so
buying a lot of chips.
I'm hoping
to bring back more chips to the window.
Yeah,
and that's this weekend.
What are you playing, blackjack or the three card poker?
Blackjack. Three card poker is kind of fun to fuck around with and stuff. But if you're serious in wanting to get in there and maybe do some damage, either way, blackjack's the game.
When are you coming back?
Sunday.
Okay.
Do you have your own table, or you just play with other players?
Oh, a host, my own table. But I have played with other people. If they're good, it's fine.
Yeah.
You don't want to play with the frail, smoking Asian gentleman that doesn't know when to hit or stay. That's a little annoying.
Yeah.
But you play in the high roller section. They all know what they're doing, so you don't have to worry about it. And is it better
to play on your own, or better to play with other players?
It's better to play with other players. I found when you and the dealer, it goes a little too fast.
Yeah, that's the problem.
It goes a little too fast.
Yeah.
I don't like the automatic shuffler. I like when they have to stop. Shuffle the shoe. I like taking a little breather.
It does show you how much of it is in your brain, though. How much of it is, like, when you play roulette. And there's a whole table full of people. You feel pretty good, but when it's just you're just one asshole.
Yeah,
it's just like you've just got these two lonely chips.
You're the lone zebra at the watering hole,
and the fucking ball falls like 10 miles away from where you were, and you realize how dumb. That's when you realize how dumb roulette is.
Yeah,
when there's like every number has a chip on it, you're like, one of us is.
Because every time someone's like, I won, you're like, hey, that could be me.
Yeah,
and then
you're
alone,
on two red and.
You realize how many numbers you can't cover.
Yeah,
that's impossible. How long as you've ever played?
Oh,
fuck.
My God.
Probably 20 hours.
Sober.
Oh, really? Sober?
Yeah.
8 minutes.
As long as it took for the first drink to arrive.
Usually when I sit down, the first thing I'll do is order a drink.
Sure.
But you really do have to be careful, though. Because you can't get too fucked up. They'll try to feed you, drink. You got to be able to think reasonably. But it helped one time. it ended up, it was somewhere around 6 in the morning. Keith the cop was sitting there. I was getting pretty, hammered, but I was way up. And I was kind of, oh, nice sound effect. Wow. Tom would love this.
Sure.
But I was getting too tired. I would have stayed there. And I was up, but I was like, you know something? I'm just too fucking tired to continue.
Yeah.
So I walked away with the chips and walked away ahead.
Yeah.
But I would have stayed there until, the pile went down a little. Should I leave? No. Yeah. Stay until you win that back.
No, your body has more financial sense than your brain
does. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Kenny Rogers said it best. That's right.
Come in my beard.
That's right. Hey, Gatlin boys, go fuck Becky.
Come in my beard.
That's his famous line, right?
I feel like I'm there.
That's a line from his famous song.
It really is, yes. The cum guzzler of the county.
It's a B-side. Everyone,
right. Yeah. We know he's the coward,
he's
right?
He's crying on his fucking daddy's picture.
Sucks.
Hey, sissy.
Where's Danny?
Dang it.
We got to get the Bob Kelly puking audio on.
Oh, my God, yes.
Yeah.
Bobby. We've been teasing this for a few days, but Danny's saying this is the best puke you've had yet. It's from your Saturday Night Virus show, right?
Saturday Night
Puke
Show.
Well, this girl was explaining...
Oh, I followed this shit, didn't I? You mean when, on one of the virus... Oh, no, from your Saturday Night
Virus. No, no,
no. I thought you meant from the virus tour.
No, no,
I just
no.
remember him puking on stage, and then now me. Oh, good. Fucking slipped in his puke.
The girl was talking about... we were talking about yeast infections.
Mm.
And they were actually...
Hot.
Just in depth going into what a yeast... I always thought... Jimmy explained to me a yeast infection is that milky...
Yeah, white stuff.
Elmer's glue.
But yeah. Apparently it can turn lumpy.
Mm-hmm.
Like cottage cheese.
Right?
And then they actually... they use a suppository to help, and you have to put that in. But that actually creates another mixture. Mm-hmm. Almost like a...
Wow, you're making a white Russian in there.
Like
how long does a yeast infection have to go for before it hits these different stages?
6 months.
Wow.
Then she fucking like baking a fucking cake.
They pull a Pepperidge Farm box out of a cunt.
It's like a Dutch oven.
We got Danny in studio. Danny?
Well, now, by saying it was the best one ever, I just want to just preface this by saying it's not the best audio of Bob puking ever, yeah, but it was definitely his best puke as far as volume and consistency.
Oh, wow.
Oh, you actually...
It came out projectile, but it because something hit me because I have something happened to me a long time ago when I was when I used to drink and party and shit when I was younger. Me and my friends would all get trashed and fucked this woman, this retarded woman named Connie.
Let me just jump in and go. You don't say woman like retarded woman. Like that's a casual aside.
I don't know if she was retarded more than she might have been mentally ill. More than retarded. It wasn't like she was going, I like cock. It was more, she would repeat herself like, yeah, 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 come on in, yeah, 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 yeah. But she was around 35.
Get the papers, get the papers.
Get the papers.
Wapner. Wapner's on at 5. So. So We're on a bus. We're on an abandoned
school
bus.
She was retarded enough not to wash her pussy.
Apparently so.
Where I think this story's going.
We were on we all got stoned. We met her on this abandoned school bus in an alley or something.
How old is she, Bubby?
This sounds like a rape, by the way.
Of course. That was another day.
Christ.
But there was around 4 of us or 5 of us. And...
You just happened upon some woman who hangs out in
the door open. Empty bus.
I got nervous. It was the fucking cops.
Yeah. Well.
So I was the last one in.
Oh, fuck. Oh my God. Oh my God. You fucking cream pie, didn't you, sissy boy?
You cream.
You fucking. You're a buddy cuckold. He laid on the back of the bus and she fucking squatted low into his mouth.
No.
Jesus, please.
Cream no,
pie. Boston cream nuts. Pies.
Jesus. That's what you know. No, it's not your fantasy boy. Relax.
Did it just all squish out the side? Yeah.
No.
Bob's mouth looked like a fucking cappuccino.
Oh, God. With the brown part, too.
Oh.
Not just the white foam, but the brown flecks.
That's disgusting, Bob.
Yeah, well.
All right. Fucking a crack addict on my
Bob
fucking
saw
couch
that
with a bloody
and
pussy.
Said, fuck it, I'm going in anyway.
No, I didn't. I was too young. I think I was 14. I was too young.
God,
I didn't know anything
damn
about
it.
Pussy.
And you were 14?
I was doing it because. I was doing it because, you know, hey, dude, you go fucking now. I didn't know how to really what I was doing or what it was all about. I knew I had to just go.
Now you know how to fuck a retarded girl's frothy.
Absolutely.
Pussy.
Now you know how to man up.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, you'd be number
Back
one
then.
Or two. You're not number five. You're
no,
not number five.
No.
And she,
why are you paranoid every time someone walks in?
He walks behind me and he's got a lot of wind with him. I don't like it. Fucking wide asshole. So I went over there and her, I guess, now I understand. I never understood it all these years, but now I guess her pussy, I guess she might have came.
No.
And you know how when women's.
No, it was other
she
people's
did,
cum.
Well, no, what happened is she came, I think she came and she discharged.
No, she had an infection.
Whatever it was.
And
it shot out.
What, did she have squirted?
It shot out.
like, dude, not squirting. It didn't squirt. Squirt is too cute for what happened.
Gushed.
Gushed is a word I'd use. Gushed. Shot.
Okay. No, what happened was that she started peeing, and the pee pushed all the four guys' thumb out.
That's right. It was,
and then she later had the bastard's child of five disgusting losers from Boston.
In the back of a bus. So fucking...
It came out like cum oatmeal.
Oh, God.
How did it smell?
It did, I don't remember the smell at all. I just remember that it got in my pubes.
Oh, God damn it to hell.
Dude.
It was like somebody threw oatmeal on your box.
Look at the girl's face out there. She is so... you are so disgusted.
Are you going to say aristocrats at the end of this? Fucking disgusting.
Yeah.
One of the listeners out there
never
heard anything like this in my life.
My friends all laughed, though. They were like, look at that, you cock.
Yeah, I didn't see it.
What was she saying or doing? Was she crying or sleeping or what was her?
She was. I think she was saying.
Was she telling jokes?
Was she putting fruit in her pussy?
She was counting matchsticks on the floor. Oh, 367. 367. What's that matches? Literally, I think she actually made a move. I remember her making a move with her pelvis and her back, and it just shot.
Oh,
just gushed
and so
out.
Then you vomited.
Yeah, it was a squirter.
Yeah, I didn't know. I thought it was egg. I didn't know what happened.
Oh, she got you.
I didn't know what happened. I just didn't know what happened.
Fucking caviar shot out of her.
No. Fucking crackers. It was fucking a hen.
Did it smell? Did it
trout smell? Eggs shot out of her cunt.
It's horrible.
That's loads, man.
That's hilarious.
It was, I didn't know what it was, though. I didn't understand. I didn't know what about a fucking
vagina.
Did you taste
it? Did you taste it, Bob?
You out of your mind, you dirty fucking piece of taste it, we taste it in Britain. Fuck off.
You should have pulled it out of your pubes and sniffed it. And then put it on the tip of your tongue.
And then just between your two teeth, just kind of nibble on it.
Yeah.
Nibble.
So wait a minute.
Yeah,
she
You guys are trying to get me to puke. I get it. I get fucking stupid Afro heads in here with the camera. You nervous? He has a hard time holding that heavy camera up.
What? So she shot cunt tapioca into your balls.
I'd say more rice pudding. That tapioca is too smooth. It was clumpy. Yeah. But the... And then when she shut out, she actually got nervous, like she did a bad thing, like she did it before, and her father beat her for it.
Why did
she get
nervous?
When I shooting pussy clumps on my rug.
Oh, that made her ill at ease? That's weird. She must be very insecure.
Yeah, I guess.
A little uncomfortable after that.
So what's this audio?
I really couldn't eat anything, like, for a long time after that. It would have affected my
certainly
visual.
Certainly made up for it.
All right, well, now...
That was a lot funny. There you go. That was a lot funnier than the response it got. That's all I was saying.
Yeah, I didn't hear it.
I think it was his excited delivery.
I know.
You sure made up for that one.
Yeah, I know.
He said I wasn't able to eat anything for the longest time.
We
and then
got
Jimmy
it.
Said, you sure made up for that one.
It's true, because he's fat. It's true.
He's going to fucking punch up his joke, make it better.
It's true, because he's a fat soul. It's true, he eats a lot.
So then we get to Danny.
Yeah, so this girl was... first of all, the girls
were
talking about...
So all this was starting to conjure in your mind. You were making an association to that evening.
We were talking about pussy, and it started with a yeast infection. Yeah. And then this girl, I think, went into how she had a yeast infection and got cheesecloth and put garlic in it and put it in her vagina because someone told her that... Yeah, the girl Marla Schultz I had on the show, she put garlic in her pussy to cure a yeast infection. And forgot about it.
By the way, they dumped out a spick on the other side of the show. I just want to bring that to everyone's attention.
Yeah.
And pissed away.
Yeah, pissed away.
Right, just so you can understand the world we live in.
This will probably get dumped over there, too.
Yeah. They dumped out faggot and spick. Yeah. And over here, we're talking about
tapioca cunt. I think it would get dumped out. Too.
All right, so let's play the audio. So that was all in your head when this girl called your show, right?
Put cheesecloth in her box.
All right, let's listen to this.
Have you had a yeast infection?
Yes, I think every girl has had a yeast infection.
Well, what happens? Does your pussy expire?
No, it doesn't expire. It's like, some stinky cock probably gave you a little, you probably got something from the guy, because guys have yeast infections too. Mm. And then what happens is it just like... cultivates and it's like thick and it can be like kind of gross, you know?
What do you mean thick? Like a milkshake?
No, like cottage cheese.
Yeah, they call it the cottage cheese disease.
Really?
Yeah, because if you pee, you look in the toilet, and there's like little pieces of glass. I mean, that's the discharge. Oh. It's true, though.
Oh my God, he's gonna throw up.
Oh, God. Oh. What's wrong with this? It just discharged.
You fucking, you discharged South Beach diet out of your cunt? What
yeah, that's,
the
that's
fuck?
How you know you have a yeast infection, besides the smell. You the smell.
Cottage cheese comes out of your vagina?
They call it the cottage cheese disease.
Does it make a plop sound when it goes in?
It's not that thick. It's just
little pieces, little chunks.
It's like, it's like when you boil raviolis for too long.
My God.
Louie, you can't. What happens?
Nothing.
Your vagina, what do you do for it?
You gotta take medicine.
Monistat.
What is it?
Monistat.
Monistat. So you gotta go to CVS and buy Monistat.
Yeah,
and
that's all you need.
That's
just a suppository.
And you put it in your vagina.
Stick it in there.
And then what happens?
And then you actually, it's worse than, it's worse, because then a lot of stuff comes out.
Like what?
Like the cottage cheese and the Monistat.
Wait a minute.
All sorts coming out.
Like if you're.
Oh my God!
Oh my God, you really threw up! Oh my God!
Holy
oh my
shit! That was a lot of puke, Bobby. Holy
he really
shit!
Puked?
Oh, all right. Listen,
Danny, take us to break. Take us to break.
No. And we're back live.
And Louie, I noticed as he's listening,
Louie
he's
can't
the
listen.
Kills in a puking.
I can't write not right into my ears like that.
Why?
Through headphones. It's just I don't know. It makes it unsettles my stomach to hear puking like that. Not a lot, but, you know, I'm not usually squeamish. I can look at bloody things and stuff like that. And,
cool.
Know. Yeah, no problem. Shit and puke upsets me a little bit.
Puke is bad, though.
Yeah, shit, puke, and other people's cum.
Error in judgment, by the way. Imagine that, Lou.
See, that's kind of cartoony. I don't mind that. That's all right.
That's
that
real,
sounds
though.
Funny. That's silly.
That's real.
Yeah, but that sounds okay.
Pass from Unucky, right?
Yeah.
Oh,
well, that's a little.
That's it.
The last one. Where there's no heat.
Yeah.
Just water.
Oh. Did you ever see the Sergeant McGoo video? You guys?
Oh, that's all right.
Oh,
Jesus. That's a lot of puke.
Yeah,
man.
That's bad.
Let me see what this one sounds like.
Oh, God.
All right, how about this one?
Oh.
That's a good one. That's a good one. It's a dry heave, and then you hear a little stuff.
The thing is, I have a huge aversion to puke. Like, I can't. I hate puking. It hurts.
Yeah, yeah.
I find it so painful and upsetting.
Yeah.
Like, when I have food poisoning or something, you know, if you feel food poisoning, if you puke, it's over the instant you puke. I will hold it in.
Ride it out.
Let the poison course through my veins, my whole body. And I will host that poison for, like, 48 hours rather than puke.
Yeah.
And I'll just sit there shivering. Run a temperature up to like 115. And fucking see my
how do you have a choice,
feet
though,
are turning yellow.
Doesn't it just make
I
you
hold
puke?
It down. I hold
There's
it down.
A way.
I think some people have a more like an easy switch to anti-gesticulate. I think it's
just
called.
Fucking puke.
I can't, yeah, but for me, puking, like my body just it puts
I'm
me through a lot of pain.
I'm fingers down the throat puke. Like, no.
I've never been able to do that
God.
In my life.
Nope.
Never in my life been able to do
I'm
that.
Right the same down the way.
I cry
puking.
And scream when I'm puking. I literally like go, no, I don't want to. I have a huge problem.
It is
with
weird.
It.
No one likes it.
Oh, it's
just
but there are people
puke.
That can just go, bleh, I'm done. I think it's something about how your body's made, like your pipes work a certain way. Some people don't go in a reverse nicely.
I got to ask Louie, have you seen Two Girls, One Cup?
Oh, that's a good one.
That's
two
just
girls,
silly.
One cup?
Yeah,
it's no, silly.
It's
what
just,
is
just
two
silly.
Girls,
silly. That, turn around. Put on all the TVs,
just
I want to see it. Hold on, all the TVs.
This is just
a little Lesbo clip.
It's just silly, Louie.
It's a fucking, I don't even think they're that hot to make it out.
Yeah,
I don't think
it's
that
got
hot.
Its own website. This one clip has its own
yeah,
website.
Yes, it's just silly.
Well, it's because they're fucking making out. It's silly.
Hold on, we're putting it on all the TVs. All
right.
Just in case you turn this way, you can still see it.
Yeah.
Here we go. All right, just take a look. Please don't look away.
Okay.
Why would he? Unless he wants to jerk off.
It's about a minute.
What are they, Brazilian girls?
Yeah.
Okay, lesbian nice action. Girl. Nice, right?
Warm. Black girl, white girl.
Oh, my God.
Jesus Christ. What the fuck?
Oh!
That's just wrong. Isn't it?
Pause it.
You gotta watch it. Pause it.
Wait a minute.
Dirty bitch.
Louie.
Oh, you dirty bitch. I like Gavin's reaction. Oh, Gavin, you dirty Gavin, bitch.
Gavin's cock is hard right now.
I'm switching, I'm switching. Cheeky bitch.
Bobby's not okay. Looking. Bobby's not looking.
Bobby.
I don't like this.
That's
Bobby.
Bobby.
Come on, Bobby. I can't even look what's on the screen now.
That's not okay. I just had a Jamba Juice.
How could you not watch the most famous clip on the internet
that,
right
that,
now?
That twirled like soft serve. Like
it came out.
In.
Yeah, it was amazing how quickly the cup.
The
filled.
Best part. This is the part, Bobby. You guys see right after she shits. Yeah, Paul, pause this a minute. Okay. Watch the asshole because it goes like this. It gives it, the asshole gives a kiss, and what? The shit stickiness which connects the shit. It's like shit string.
There's two strings.
Watch.
That is stinky poo.
Watch, wait.
Watch the last
hold
part.
On.
And
you see the little strings?
Yes.
Bobby, look.
Sure.
Bobby, look.
No, I'm not puking.
Bobby,
no,
you puke. No, no, I'm not your fucking dumb fan.
I was the same way about this clip
pretend
when I first
else.
Saw it.
You pretend
and now
something
I can watch
have diabetes.
It like no
I'm not
problem.
Fucking
sure.
Losing electrolytes for you.
But don't you think that you somewhere you paid a price for the immunization?
Yes, my sensitivity.
Now, Louis, try to get to the end of the clip, please.
Wow, look at that.
Please.
Okay, go ahead.
Nice speech.
We've all done it. We've all made it to the end.
I'm pretending it's something else. That's
yeah.
All.
Yes.
All right.
Oh, that's her shit, you God.
Look at that. She's having fun with it.
I see.
Roll in her mouth. She's sucking. Look how brown her tongue is.
Roll that around in your mouth.
Hey, Louie.
Her fucking tongue is, dude, her tongue is coffee ice cream brown.
I got nothing to gain by watching that.
I'm doing a nice fat heart on myself. What do you eat to get shit like that?
Yeah, that's the other thing.
It's
not
the worst shit.
Are you going to go shopping?
She eats it now. That girl eats McDonald's too much.
And what do you eat to get shit like that? That's someone else's shit.
That's like that's like fifth generation
is it more,
shit.
Is it more?
That's
is
like
more
her shit after eating her shit. If you kept doing that,
she's environmentally conscious. She only recycles other.
If you kept doing that, just to keep. Somebody shits in your mouth, and then you shit into someone else's mouth. Eventually, a diamond comes out of you. It must be the cure for cancer. What if that turned out to be the cure for cancer? That people have to, like, 15 times shit in each other's mouths?
Norton would never get cancer. I'd be a
regenerated.
Fucking cancer-free boy. Stop stalling.
All right, here we go.
Almost
what happens
she's in between her teeth.
That's great, yeah.
Oh, she's smiling.
And she doesn't get
no way! Dirty fucking bitch! French kiss him with shit?
Yes.
Yeah, now the girls are making out.
The thing that's upsetting about it is how...
we only got
the thing that's upsetting about it is the looks on their faces because they don't care. They don't care. They are so fucking nonchalant about this.
Oh, God.
You know what that room must smell like?
Oh, my God.
The whole room.
Oh, God. I just feel bad.
It's not a big mystery. I doubt it's perfume or financial success.
Smells like a pediatrics ward.
I watched it again because I'm like, oh, how much worse can it get? She shit into an ice cream cone. Yes. They both ate it. And then the other one's showing it off in her mouth. Okay, I'll watch
how
it.
How much worse? Can it get?
It's a lot worse.
All right, well, let's
look at the screen.
Let's see how much it's worse.
It's like they're making out with fucking cookie dough in their mouths.
How much do they get fucking paid for
probably not a lot. Brazil, man.
Perfume and
I'm going there tomorrow. It's amazing.
All right. Fucking Jimmy, man.
Yeah, hello.
See, this is what the Writers Guild is fighting for, by the way. These girls should be getting paid for us watching
this. This should be
Xbox. All right,
here we go.
Bobby, come on.
Someone had to write this, right?
Here we go.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right. I'm not going
to
watch it.
No, you have to.
Yeah. I'm looking there.
All right, look over there, Louie.
God!
Louie!
We're never going to get to the end of
this.
The
one girl is puking shit onto the other cup of shit.
Yes.
What do you expect to do with it?
Gavin's going to puke.
Gavin's going to puke!
Oh,
Gavin's
shit.
Gavin's going to puke. Here, give him a fucking bucket. Don't give him a
fucking bucket. Here's the garbage belt. Over there,
Gavin. Get
here's the garbage belt.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I'm about to laugh at the puke at the same time.
Here's the mic.
He puked on the mic.
He puked on the mic.
He
now Louis is leaving. Louis leaving the studio. Louis just walked out. Oh, the show's a catastrophe.
We just knocked out the 6'5", 290-pound English leg. He's out. He's tapping out.
Holy shit.
Please support him, man.
You need water.
That is the worst film I've seen in my fucking life.
Sam, where's your camera?
Oh, God.
Okay, well, you're not filming.
I didn't miss
that.
Oh.
Is it over? No, we're not done yet.
We're almost done.
Wow.
We're almost done. This clip's
on. No, I'm done.
Fucking.
No, this clip's only 45 seconds.
Come on. This is like heroin.
Food on my table.
Where's Bobby?
After a while, you'll be turning people onto this thing. You'll be going, dude, you see this?
It's like hanging out with the cast of Waiting to Exhale. You fucking man up and watch it.
There's no reason. I don't get paid to watch it. It doesn't help the country.
That last part took out three guys.
It's no socially redeeming value.
Social security.
Yes, the Bob Kelly Live Club all bailed out on that fucking puke. You never seen anybody puke on a cup of shit before? You're sheltered,
enjoy it, but if I watch it, an angel doesn't get its wings. Because I watched some cunt puke another cunt's shit into
Gavin. Can we get some water for Gavin, please? Man. Finish this clip.
Gavin will at least get to the end of the clip. We're almost there.
Just don't drink coffee if you watch this, anybody.
I think we got the grand finale coming up.
Where's fucking Bobby?
Where's the bin?
Bobby snuck out. He's done.
Is he coming? Oh, Bobby's over there.
I got it.
Bobby, talk on mic. What happened?
Bob's
in the other studio.
Bob.
At least say what happened.
How can Bobby scare us of being sick?
He's a fucking... Ugh.
That.
Oh,
look
man.
At that. She's just... Thanks, buddy.
Wow.
It's
like her mouth right there.
We started a chain effect we didn't want.
That scene is the bad scene right there, I guess. Huh?
Come on, guys. Let's fucking man up and finish. Yeah, man up. Seconds left.
Let's all man up. Let's man up.
Here we go.
Man up. Here we go. Come on, rally.
Here we go.
Rally time. Come
all right.
on. Oh, come on.
Pull it together, everybody.
All right. Why don't we go back a little bit, because they...
Yeah, that's what you want to do.
Just a little. Okay, to that scene. Yeah, but you've seen this already.
Yeah, look at the way this shit's between her teeth. Isn't that wonderful?
All right, come on. She's going to need a good flossing.
With a tampon string.
All right, here we go. Come on, let's all rally. It's Friday.
Man.
Heading toward the weekend. Here we go. Here we go.
Come on, Lou.
Come on, Lou.
Man up.
Louis closing one eye already. Come on, Lou.
All the guys are laughing.
We saw that.
It's all better.
The French kiss with the shit.
She
pukes in the fucking theater.
Eats it. Slurps it up. And then a nice shit puke right in the mouth.
What the fuck?
And a close up.
Louis out! He's thrown the headphones down, he's done! He's kicking furniture over! He's kicking the furniture over! He's had it!
Don't wreck our studio!
He's had it, I love it!
He's not happy! I've learned something about Louis today!
That clip made him angry! Oh, did he get angry?
Gavin, you all right?
I can't unwatch that. I can't unwatch that.
Louis on mic way over
that's
there.
That's in my memory.
Unwatch.
Watch your head.
That's it.
Yeah, that last
it's
clip.
Irreversible damage.
That one woman just has like Reagan's hair in her mouth. It's hanging out.
All right, well.
Jesus.
Have you seen Lemon Party?
I like the fucking puke in the mouth, and I think it's funny that they close with the shit eating.
And they're like in an office where they're both receptionists or something, and they got bored.
They're probably on a break.
Yeah, you gotta make make it believable. There's Lemon Party.
All right, this up scene.
Yeah, that's nothing.
Oh, no.
That's nice.
I showed this to my wife once, and she said, she saw this, and she said, you know what, that's kind of sweet. She said it's the only pornography she's ever seen where there's no victims. Everybody's happy here.
We're trying to figure out who is the gayest guy in that shot.
Oh, it's got to be the guy
who's
got the
talk in his mouth.
He's holding the
guy. It's not even the gayest guy. Here it is.
I think the guy paid for it.
You have to be one of these guys. Yeah. Which one is it?
The guy sucking cock.
The cameraman.
That's the smart answer. But if you had to be one of those three.
I think the dude kissing, the guy whose dick isn't involved and he just has his hand on the dude's chest.
What is he getting out of that?
His red dog dick is poking to the side.
And I mean, it's got to be that than being blown by an old man or blowing an old man.
I'd rather
Jack Nicholas, we call him. It's Jack Nicholas. And he's blowing Ed Koch.
And John Witherspoon.
Dick smells. Thurston Howell the third.
Thurston Howell. Yeah.
Hey, Matt LaFarr writes, he wants to know if Louis would rather watch Two Girls, One Cup or listen to Val Kilmer sing.
Oh, Jesus. Well, that should be the soundtrack.
God, that's awful. Daddy, who's your, hold your daddy, whatever, blah,
that's
blah,
just,
blah.
That's just wrong, isn't it?
In every
way.
I've seen much worse than that. You've seen Meat Spin, right?
What?
Meat Spin?
No, I don't watch this kind of shit. I just don't.
These
and I don't have a shit problem. I mean, like, I have a 2-year-old, and I change her diaper, and it's chaos in there.
It's chaos.
It's just fucking mountains of shit, and I clean it out of her cunt, which I've talked about on the air here. So I don't mind, you know, vaginas and shit are natural, you know, occurrence, out one hole in the other. But I don't know why that's so upsetting to me. It's really just these...
You broke
her eyeshadow.
Broke our stuff, man.
She had this cheap blue eyeshadow and this cunty look on her face.
They tend to not overspend on makeup during the fucking Brazilian shit films.
How'd you cast one of those jumps?
You've never heard this on a Brazilian shit film set. Could you fix my lipstick?
Cut, cut, cut.
Yeah, you never hear cut. Exactly. Unless somebody says something kind. Can we do that? Can we do that again? Yeah, tomorrow.
Could you hold it, please?
Or can we wait? I have to pick up a Father's Day card.
I saw a really bad video one time. It was a Japanese guy on his back, and there was a toilet seat over him, but he was like mummified, and he had like a fucking hose attaching under the toilet
taped
to his mouth, and a bunch of girls were just like liquid shitting into it, and you could see it like
like a where bird. Is that?
I don't know.
I gotta
fucking
see that.
Wonderful.
Fuck.
Hey, are we allowed to show the horse video? That you talk about every once in a while?
Yeah. I've seen that. Yeah. That I've seen.
What's this one now going?
This is fucking. This is me in a horse costume.
Fucking a man.
Were you the head or the ass?
We have it.
I don't know. I'm looking.
Find Mr. Head.
I just. Wait, what are you showing to everybody
get
there?
My breath.
What's this one?
The guy from The Wire.
I don't know. Somebody just feedbacked it in.
What is it?
Look at the behind the guy talking.
Oh, there's a casket.
The dead guy.
All right, dead guy
there
at a wake.
Seems to be.
He puked into the casket?
Yeah. Oh, my God!
He puked on a dead man?
Is that real?
Fake.
He puked on a dead man?
Fake.
Considering you can't see the actual guy vomiting, I'm a little skeptical.
Yeah, that's fake.
Right, that was a waste. Fuck Ebon out of his world. How about fucking, get to fucking,
what do I type
Mr.
In?
Hands. Google Mr. Hands.
Mr. Hands.
Mr. Hands.
Where are we going?
This is fucking great.
Mr. Hands?
Yeah, it's a fucking hot video, man.
I'm still.
That is really disgusting. But like being, I equate it to being in warfare. Like we've seen it so many times that you guys are the replacements that have come in, and you're throwing up over the bodies, and we're just like, guys, fucking get rid of this shit in your pack. You're not gonna need that in the field.
I never liked this kind of shit. I don't, you know, like I remember before the internet and all that. Somebody tried to show me a tape of, you know, it was Marilyn Chambers and some guy's shoving a bowling pin up her pussy. Like losing
not
a bowling
sexy.
Pill in her pussy, and I'm like, I don't want to see all this shit.
Nah.
It's just gross.
Shit's bad. I think in a month you guys will be showing this video to everybody.
I'll look at anything sexual.
Yeah.
Anything.
Yeah.
Even the shit video. I just don't like real violence and
death
shit.
Yeah, that stuff is a bummer too.
Like people watch the killings and beheadings.
Yeah.
I can't watch that. Anything sexual, though, put it on. Yeah. I'll watch it.
That was the
don't
one
care.
That affected me the most. The beheadings.
Those are bad.
Violate you. Like, this is gross and yuck. But I watched Eugene Armstrong's fucking head being cut off.
Yeah.
And it hits you on like a fucking bizarre level.
The worst detail
sleep.
I remember from those is a guy was screaming and then it goes through his throat and the scream turns into just this wheeze.
It's Eugene.
I didn't know that.
Because it's not going through. It's just air pushing
he's
out
trying
of
trying to breathe.
Yeah.
Like a pig. You sound like a pig.
Oh, yeah. God. Yeah. Why would you watch
and then they hold,
that?
And then they hold it. They always hold the head up to the camera, and it's got this dumb look on its face.
Yeah.
It's just he goes from, to like.
Like he just lost a tooth.
He looks like a moron.
It looks like he's either beheaded or he's losing a trivia show.
Yeah, exactly.
The blaze.
I don't have a body anymore, dad.
That is fucking horrible.
That's what happened.
I've seen like still pictures.
Oh my god, I'm in this other country and my wife, my kids, and all this profound, and then just
yeah, like every you know what it is. Yeah, your eyes don't face forward anymore. Yeah. They're kind of. And your mouth.
Do what they want to do. Yeah.
Oh, that is horrible.
At least you hope it's over quickly.
What an awful way to go.
Shit.
Because the thing is, they're sawing through the head with a knife.
I know. It's not like a guillotine where it's like like that.
Do you ever see the one that was done? There was two people they beheaded out in public. And the guy, the head won't come off, so he has to take the knife and like keeps chopping it through the neck, and the head won't come off.
You must feel that your neck coming away, like coming loose. You
of course
must
you
feel
do.
Your
the
head coming away
still
from your body.
Oh, that's like so bad.
And your spine is still connected, so until that's cut, you're alive.
Nah, you lose fucking once the blood isn't going to your brain anymore.
Yeah,
you're
but that's
done.
The thing is, if you're cutting from the back, which they seem to usually do.
Oh, if you're cutting from the back. Oh,
from the front, then you lose your first. You're choking on blood.
Yeah,
and then you start getting really tired.
Is it really a little sleepy?
And weirdly, you get bored in the middle.
Yeah.
That's worse than shit eating video.
Then you feel like a little prankster. You want to do wacky things. Yeah.
And then you wonder where your keys are.
Then you get forgetful. That's what happens. You lose short term
memory.
How
awful would it be if the last thing you have is, I wonder who's going to fuck my wife first?
Oh,
I'm telling you, who knows what your mind
God
goes.
Hangs up
on sorry, was that a little too unpleasant for everybody?
Hey, you crossed the line.
No, I was just thinking about it. That's
I didn't mean to go too far, guys.
Sorry.
By the way, you're not married, so you don't know.
Video.
You can tell you're not married because the last thought is, oh, my wife is a cunt.
Have we seen Pain Olympics yet? They keep trying to push Pain Olympics on us.
No, I don't want to see shit like that.
I don't know if we've seen Pain Olympics.
Looks fine.
I won't watch.
I don't know if we've seen
Why can't you watch
it? I don't know what it's about. I don't like
hurtful things. I don't like painful things. I don't like people in pain.
Know what video we should show these guys?
Out on the limb there, Anthony.
The guy,
yeah, really.
The guy smashing in his own fucking butt plug with his dick.
That's just funny.
That is hilarious.
That's just silly is what that is.
Yeah, go to eatabullet.com.
Eatabullet.com.
Yeah, I was too excited.
Hey, you wanted to get that out. Yeah, you're almost excited. Acting too. Go to eatabullet.com. Rachel. Mr. Fabershan, go to eatabullet.com.
Eatabullet. fucking you are.
What are you? go fuck yourself.
What time is it? Oh, shit.
Yeah, we're getting ready to get out of here.
11
Where's
seconds.
Where's Mr.
Away.
Hands?
It's,
what are you, fuck, on a dial-up?
Our 40K connection.
Ooh.
Oh!
Judo Than just came out.
That look Than gave Jimmy might earn him an email.
With his strike beard.
Uh-oh.
Scary.
All right.
What are you, the playoffs?
So it's either going to be the video or a horrific virus. So
let's hope it's both.
Yeah. All right.
This is the video.
All right.
Deep thrust.
This doesn't bother me.
Oh, this is the horse, right?
This stuff gets me.
I've seen the horse.
Yeah, you like it's fine. This? Watch how eager the horse is to push that big dick into this fella.
Is Mr. Hands the horse?
Yeah. No, Mr. Hands is the guy that died.
Oh, God.
Oh. Now.
There he goes. Look at this silly rascal.
What an awful ass.
All right. Wow.
Get the fuck out.
No way.
And this guy dies.
Now, this guy's supposed to keep the horse's dick from going all the way in.
What?
Yeah, that's what his buddy's doing.
Oh, God.
He's going like, don't worry, I got it. I got it. Don't worry, I got it.
Look at the little clothespins on his balls.
But now the horse says, you know, I mean business.
Oh,
he's got clothes.
He buried it.
Look at his asshole coming out with the dick. Like coming.
Stop him.
How could his legs up and give
him
Oh, it shot a fucking hot
The horse is like, I don't get to come in him.
That horse has no dick control.
So he has clothespins on his balls.
Was that Gavin on your couch?
So he's got clothespins on his balls, because without those, like, this wouldn't really feel, you wouldn't feel nothing.
Otherwise, you feel silly.
Otherwise, it's just like,
What a dope the other guy is thinking he could control the horse with one fucking hand.
It's a fucking horse.
Yeah, holding the horse's dick back with one hand. Yeah,
he's
like
not, he's definitely not
a concussion.
All right,
I ain't watching.
This is the Pain Olympics.
Pain Olympics.
No.
Hit come play. On.
Yeah, hit play.
Talking about cheese.
You guys.
It's because I hadn't made a full screen, Jeff.
All right, here's okay. Thank you, Thanikin.
All right, here's Olympics.
Why does a guy have a cutting board, a knife, and his dick is out?
Yeah, that's all he's making cheese and standing up.
That's all I gotta say.
This is what happens when you fuck a chick with a cottage cheese.
There you go.
What's he happening?
He's just shaving a little bit.
No big deal.
What is he doing? What is happening? His dick with a knife. It's a fucking child's play.
It's the Olympics. That's it.
I'm not interested.
He's tying his balls up. Tying his
balls up
and time. It's a rodeo dick.
Tied it up in a little.
Look at this little fucking penis.
No big deal, see?
Oh, wait a minute.
Hey.
What's he gonna do?
Stop.
What's he gonna do? That's fake. I've done that. Wait a minute.
That's fake.
That's fake.
I'm not watching.
That might not be fake.
That's fake.
That might not be fake, dude.
Shut up.
You can tell by the way he's sitting right there.
Fake. Yeah, I'm done.
Is that fake?
I don't know what that one is.
Jesus Christ.
That's goddamn like real.
That looks like my grandmother's pussy.
Ah, you dirty fuck.
Maybe that might be real.
Wait a minute. That looks real. That might, he cut his balls out.
Louis,
that's
covering
real.
His eyes.
I'm done.
That dude, might that's be real. His balls George came out. They're so cute. His fucking
balls.
Is that
fake or real?
How can it be fake? Who did this?
I don't know. You can fucking
DreamWorks? his dirty fingernails. High production.
DreamWorks.
Why?
CGI magic.
The guy had fucking grit in his fingernails. This is real.
Could get an infection.
Oh, that's
yes.
What, are you getting back to Rachel Ray now?
Yep.
They're cooking the same thing on her show.
Oh,
you know what? We got to get out of here.
Yeah.
There's nowhere else to go after that.
I got shit
but
to do.
Home. Yeah. So don't forget, you can see Patrice at Levittown at Governor's, Bob Kelly tonight, tomorrow, Sunday, Caroline's, and January 18th, his Comedy Central special comes out, which you'll be in before then anyway. And, of course, Louis C.K. in Miami Wednesday night.
Knoxville and Louisville this weekend.
Knoxville and Louisville.
And then you got Buffalo, Cleveland.
Buffalo, Cleveland, and Detroit. over the
February
14th.
14th, 15th, 16th.
And I want to plug for myself, just look up my MySpace. I got a bunch of gigs I'm doing. One's in Minnesota, which is almost sold out. And Cleveland, second show is almost sold out. So
very cool.
That's all I got to say to you, fucks.
All right.
You guys want to do line?
Denver, not so good.
There were so many.
Albany could be better.
Hold on. Sorry.
There were just so many lines of the day.
All right, we'll do line of the day.
Every line.
I'm not reading all that. BoatDogFantasy.net gives you the line of the day. A listener won $4,000 from them. And they got a trip to Vegas they're giving away right now if you go to BoatDogFantasy.net. There you go. Runner-up line of the day.
But Tourgasm was dumping really hard. Like, there was one point where Tourgasm would go down, and then a shitty like movie from like with whoever in it.
Jan Michael Vincent.
Yeah, like a Jan Michael Vincent movie that came on after.
Very nice, nice reference.
It's charitable.
Somebody doesn't like Jan Michael Vincent.
Yeah. Oh, jeez.
Yeah. Oh, what did Jan Michael Vincent do? Step on your toes one time.
You just move on. The show's almost over. Judgmental Muppet.
I'm teasing, of course.
It's not like he nominated himself. Just somebody else back there did it.
Yeah. All right. All right. Yeah,
thanks.
Another runner-up line of the day.
We're amazing at that.
What do you mean we're?
I don't understand why you keep grouping yourself in, Spick. You're a red-headed plumber. You're a farmer.
Yeah, but see, that's the thing.
Go
that's how
my
great.
My spinach. Stop with the weed.
Go pick my spinach.
And Patrice was sick today, too.
Yes. Patrice is such a racist.
He was a trooper. Another runner-up line of the day.
Because he's a filthy Mexican. He doesn't deserve anything.
All right.
Hey. Loves me. Go back to Mexico and get a computer. Go back to Mexico and invent a computer out of beans, you fucking smelly spick.
Jesus.
Wow, the fucking Hispanics took quite a beat today.
Yes.
Yeah,
sure.
In your hands.
Breaking my dad's heart today. yet again. The final runner-up line of the day.
Care about any black people? Any black stories on there?
What's that?
You know, some kid from Compton that lost his Air Force One.
No,
that,
I don't
any
care.
Any black cry stories?
Black no,
kid came in
no.
And stole all the cases and ran off.
That's what.
Gavin, you good? Everyone good?
I feel good.
Right. Yeah, I'm enjoying my smoothie.
All right, we're gonna do the line
it's
of the
like
day.
Puking shit.
Ugh.
Was it dead animal in the bathroom, by the way?
From you?
No, an animal's dead in that bathroom.
Oh, it smells like a fucking zoo.
No, there's a dead rat in the up in the rafters.
Oh, this little fella.
Something's dead in there.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Just don't eat your egg salad in there. Just saying.
Trying to give advice, everybody's looking at me.
Here's your line of the day.
Here comes
Line of the day.
You know,
two tin cans and a string.
It's
strung between a black guy and a white guy.
None's going to help.
You're just going to get trapped.
So the black people got to stop stealing, and gay people have to stop hurting God. And Jews have to stop manipulating the media.
Gregorio!
Louis C.K., line of the day. Very good.
That's funny. And
that's how we end it. And have a great weekend.
Yes.
In Mohegan?
Yes, I will.
Safe flight.
Thank you, sir.
We should have a few good stories on Monday, huh?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
I'll be in Monday because I'm going to see Diana Ross.
Do a field. You will be here.
Yes.
Sorry. Yeah. I hate that.
What happened?
I said I hope they don't Thurman Munson his plane into
No. Canton, Ohio.
Sorry. At least not on the way back if I won.
That's right.
It'd really suck.
Yeah. All right. We're out of here.
Bye.
Bye.
So. It's Flea Man from Westchester. I love Jim Norton because of his brutal honesty, his hilarious commentary on society, and that he likes to kill, rape, and eat people and admits it.
Do you have any fantasies about Jim?
I'd like to be in between him and Rich Voss and have them flip a coin to decide who fucks me. Fucks me. Fucks me. Fucks me. Fucks me.